are no strangers to scandal. Opie and Anthony on satellite radio shows host Anthony Cumia and Greg Opie.
Controversial team.
Opie and Anthony apologizing for yet another raunchy
comment. Profanity laid to rest. Is this the last straw for the raunchy radio duo?
Yay! Pudding!
The greatest show on satellite radio today.
It's entertaining as fuck.
How many people are screaming at their radios right now?
It doesn't get better than this.
It's just the stupidest, most fun.
I can't get enough of this.
I would eat your poo.
Let's be honest with each other. No one's doing better radio than this.
We rule. Google it.
You're fucking right.
Simple as that.
Fucking believe it. This is radio.
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 But enough of this palaver. Let's get the show on the road.
Good morning.
Hello.
This is the Opie and Anthony Show. And wow, man, a lot of people lost money, Anthony.
Yeah, what happened?
A lot of people lost money because there were bets going on that you would not make the show today.
I know. I told everybody I was going to be in.
And I apologize for that little Twitter game I started around 9:30 at night.
Aw, shit. What was it?
I think it almost trended.
Aw, shit.
I think we were just short of trending last night.
I heard there were a couple of Twitter games and things
A lot of Twitters. I do a lot of Twitter games, almost one a day at this point. And yesterday, we were playing... What was it called officially? What is Anthony doing now? Hold on. Where the fuck is it? And, man, did this thing explode.
Yeah, I heard about that one.
You got a fucking beating. Oh, right now, Anthony is. The hashtag.
Yeah.
So if you go to my Twitter, fuck it, I'm promoting today, Opie Radio, and you pop in right now, Anthony is, in the search engine, you'll see what everyone wrote the last 8 hours. It's ugly. It's ugly. I suggest you don't do that, Anthony.
No, I
suggest you don't do that.
It doesn't matter, because I read enough tweets... on my own personal Twitter, because, as you know, I went out last night with the lovely Taylor Vixen. She is Penthouse's pet of the year.
Mm-hmm.
And we went out to dinner,
mm-hmm.
and then went out for some drinks,
mm-hmm.
and hung out in the wonderful city of Manhattan, much like a romantic comedy.
And now she's dead.
You can find her in a dumpster in the meat packing district.
Meat market.
Yeah, well,
smooth answer.
Look, see what I was thinking?
Yeah. We're just happy he's here. I don't give a shit how smooth he is today.
Exactly. Jesus Christ.
Slur all you want. I don't give a fuck. Right now, Anthony's buying an extra pregnancy test.
Oh, yeah.
Right now, Anthony is thinking he should have dyed his pubes.
I don't have gray pubes. Shut up.
Right now, Anthony is balls deep in Penthouse pussy. It just goes on and on. There could be 1,000 of these. I don't even know. I didn't count.
I got so...
Right now, Anthony is pulling a girl from the closet for a quickie.
So, Aunt, how's her turd cutter taste? That's what I'm getting.
Right now, Anthony is packing sausage in the meatpacking district.
Mm-hmm.
Came in.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, Anthony... I'm not even trying to pick out the better ones.
Nah.
Right now, Anthony is yelling at his whiskey dick.
Whiskey dick. Shut up.
Oh, they fucking...
Asshole.
They fucking killed you on Twitter, man.
There's a lot of... mistaken for her father tweets. Grandfather here. That's nice. And a lot of I look like a creep because a few pictures were taken.
Right now, Anthony is wondering what went wrong while choking his chicken in his hotel room.
You assholes.
Right now, Anthony is hoping there's a plunger in the hotel room. That's a suggestion. You might ate too much meat.
Right.
it just goes on and on. I mean, read them for yourself. There's some fucking funny fucking listeners to this radio show.
There are definitely plenty of nasty tweets.
But you'll enjoy Right Now Anthony Is, which we started late last night around 9, 10 o'clock. That's late. That's late as far as my standards go.
Yeah.
Trying to get up for this fucking god-awful hour. I was going to say god-awful show, and I stopped myself because I like the fucking radio show. I just don't like getting up at 5 every fucking morning.
Sucks. Especially when you're busy or you're out until the wee little hours of the morning.
Yeah.
That gets a little rough then to get up. But
So how'd it go? Are you going to walk us through this or what?
It went wonderfully.
Walk us through,
nice. What do I want to walk?
You had a date with a penthouse pet, Taylor Vixen. She doesn't mind the publicity, so let's fucking get into this a little bit.
As a matter of fact, she doesn't mind it, and she doesn't mind to the fact that about 9 o'clock, I think she could be making an appearance right here in this very studio.
Oh, nice.
To come in and
proving that she's still alive.
And
that's
hang
good.
Out. Yeah,
that's
exactly.
Good.
She wants to.
That's good.
She wants her family to know she's still alive.
What the fuck did you guys do last night where you're like, can you make sure you come in here at 9 so I have an alibi?
There was a lot of meat eating.
Well, you're jumping way ahead. After the show yesterday, you went to your hotel.
Yeah.
And then crashed to get ready for the big date?
I crashed out. I watched a movie first, though.
What movie?
The Road. That post-apocalyptic movie.
Oh!
With Viggo and
kid
and stuff like that. Yeah.
Now, that I read the fucking book.
You did?
Yes. It was named one of the best books of the last 10, 20 years, something like that.
Pretty
cool.
So
I read it. The book is pretty good.
I dig any post-apocalyptic movie.
Michael Williams is in that, right?
Is
Omar?
I don't know. Is that about the father and son?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't. Yeah, I saw that in the book. The bookstore. I didn't read it.
Books? What the fuck are you talking about? I said I saw a movie.
Well, supposedly Omar's in it.
Michael K. Williams.
Yes. Michael K. Omar. Williams. Now, I read the book. The book was amazing. The movie came out, and
won't like the movie because
no one watched
the book.
But no one watched the movie. It didn't get much of a buzz when it came out.
Everybody,
I don't even think it was in a lot of
Precious and fucking.
No, I think it came out before Precious. Anyway,
because it was on the new releases kind of a thing.
So they
snuck
this movie by everyone. I'm thinking because it didn't really get a big marketing splash.
And Vigo's good.
Was it good?
You know.
Yeah.
Yeah. I like that.
All right.
Then I crashed out for a long time.
Yeah.
I figured this was going to be. One of these, I really had to time my sleep very well.
Right.
Because I didn't want to be drowsy for the night. So I fell asleep until probably 6:30.
How can you
do
that?
I'm tired.
Yeah, but you could turn your sleep on and off like that.
Yeah.
I don't understand.
I love
that.
It. So, I was very sleepy.
There's times just like you, I go home like, all right, I got a big night. If I could sleep 3 or 4 hours during the day.
3 or 4.
Then I don't have to worry about, you know, staying out a little later.
Yeah.
And then I just lay there in bed like, okay, I'm ready to sleep.
I'll sleep for 6 fucking hours.
No problem.
That was my night's sleep.
Okay.
I planned on having a night's sleep in the afternoon and then napping for an hour or two before I have to come in here.
Right.
Which is exactly what I did.
Right.
So I woke up. Got ready, in front of the mirror.
Did you have a little Frank Sinatra playing?
Oh, of course.
Getting in the mood.
Get a little Frank, brush
You're
the
Midtown
hair.
You're in Midtown Manhattan.
Put on a little cologne, you know what? No. Just getting ready.
What did you wear?
He wore a tux.
Why
did you wear a tux?
Bag. I figured a tux was appropriate for a night out.
For a meatpacking. A meatpacking night. We're calling it Anthony's meatpacking night.
My meatpacking evening.
You started with eating lots of meat and ended in the meatpacking district.
I went to the meatpacking
Enough about
district.
The meat.
I love the meat. I wore very nice clothes. Very nice,
nervous?
Button down and stuff. No, I don't get nervous anymore. Nerves are for rookies many years ago.
Right.
I used to get nervous when I was a kid. I'd have anxiety attacks. Oh, look at the nice picture right there. That is what people were saying is the creepiest picture they ever saw in their lives.
Why are you making a face like, get the fuck off me?
She's smiling. Shut
no, she's
up.
Not.
Yes, she is. And her hands are on mine. Shut up!
She's trying to she's trying to make her neck disappear.
Don't be an ass! she's smiling!
She's trying to make her neck disappear.
She's having fun, and I'm not Nosferatu biting her neck, which is
You're
what someone said.
You're trying to make her neck disappear.
No!
I mean, she is.
Anthony and fucking Langella.
Right.
Creep.
You're an asshole.
God, you're in love after 5 minutes.
Yeah. No, we were hanging
out. Why don't you play hard to get a little bit?
What? No,
it's not bad to play
cocktails.
Hard to get.
We got cocktails. It should be, cocktails. It's not. I'm not being a creep. I'm we're having fun.
Jesus, did you tell the restaurant to turn down the lights so you could take a picture together?
No, it was a very dimly lit restaurant.
There's no lights on.
And it's very dimly lit, and the iPhone, not known for its dark photography.
No, like BlackBerry way better. I'm telling you.
There's no flash, pictures. So what can I say? But, no, a lot of people dubbing that the creepiest picture they've ever seen. It's nice to see a father and daughter out for the evening as a lot of those came in.
Mm-hmm.
Another one, Anthony's biting her neck to give her immortality.
Mm-hmm.
Just plenty of vampire and old pictures.
All right, it has the same vibe as fucking Eric Roberts and his girlfriend in Star 80.
Wow, nice. All right, but you're jumping ahead. So you leave the hotel.
Left the hotel.
By the way, because we got to get some other material in. You know the other joint we used to stay at? Someone fucking jumped from the roof. You
the Parker?
The Park Meridian.
Really? That's like the second
someone
one since
jumped from the roof as the Angels were boarding their bus to go play the Yankees last night.
The Angels were staying there?
Yeah. Everybody.
It's a great hotel for like what? Yeah, I know. I stayed there once when Obama was there.
If you want to see real celebrities, just hang outside the Park Meridian on any given day. They all stay there.
Wow.
Fuck it. We'll blow up their spot a little bit today. They never gave me the suite like they gave you the fucking suite.
Oh, they gave me the presidential suite once.
The guys.
Great. Just knowing you're fucking like laying in the bed that like, you know, presidents.
I think he brings his own bed.
You think
why would he bring his own bed?
Why would he want to sleep on bed bugs?
That would be exhausting.
He doesn't carry it. His bed's a lot nicer than their bed.
He has to carry his own bed hotel.
I bet they were the bank. I hope, you know, it wasn't Obama's because.
And you're a goddamn racist because you stopped staying at that hotel after you found out Obama was in the same room as you.
That was probably the last time I stayed there when I found out Obama stayed there. I said, I shall not patronage.
We'll get back to your story, but this is a huge one today. So the Angels are in town. They're playing the Yankees, and they say a bunch of the guys were across the street at a coffee shop. That would be the Starbucks that's right there.
Oh, right, yeah.
We know this fucking area like the back of our hand.
Yeah.
So they're in Starbucks, and one of the Angels actually sees the body hit the sidewalk.
Did that put a damper on his performance for the evening? I know the Angels lost.
No, I bet you all of a sudden the guy goes, hey, here's one more Angel getting made.
Oh, Chip.
Mm. So, someone committed suicide yesterday morning around 8 a.m.
Wow, from the roof. That's a
from
tall
the roof.
Building, too.
From the fucking roof. The guy
up.
Jumped.
Maybe
they
fell.
There.
Maybe he was cleaning the gutters.
Yeah, maybe he was jumping into the pool.
Jumped. We're just talking about how suicides seem to be on the rise a couple days ago.
People a little upset with the economy.
And an 18-year-old jumped off the GWB yesterday as well.
Guy jumped off the
leaving a note in his car.
Oh,
a little suicide note as he left his car in the middle of the fucking bridge.
Isn't that great?
Blocking
traffic.
Messing up everyone else's day.
Asshole.
Just because you have decided that your life sucks, why would you make it worse for everybody else by leaving your car there?
Another guy I know got out of his car and jumped out of the Midtown Tunnel. Sprained his ankle.
Yeah, alright. If you're gonna jump off the fucking bridge, do us all a favor. You could easily walk to the middle of the bridge. I bike across that stupid bridge a lot. It's very easy.
It doesn't matter because
why don't you give it a little effort?
Off.
Huh?
They'll still rope it off of crime tape and fuck the whole thing up.
Why? The crime's in the fucking water.
Yeah, but, you know, they'll go where he jumped and they'll have to rope off like 18 feet behind where he jumped, which takes up two fucking lanes. Just jump in the river.
All right, so you got the Angels looking at that fucking suicide yesterday, and then
who saw it, though?
They lost to the
Was it somebody that is a key player?
Jared Weaver.
Was he a little distressed at bat?
He's a pitcher.
Oh, he's a pitcher. Okay.
But he said he wouldn't talk about it. So
wow.
The article that I read said that he saw the guy splat on the ground.
And then
whoa, he's fucked for the season.
And then like the two Angels, they kind of saw the body. He saw it hit, and then the other guy, saw the body laying there. Two Angels, right, Travis?
Yeah.
Was it a couple? Before the police got there.
Wow.
Yeah, just looking at the fucking pizza on the sidewalk. Yeah, enough with jumping from
selfish.
These fucking buildings, man. You're
gonna
take
Jimmy
one of
was
us
saying
out.
Yesterday about crazy people and what they do. It's just such a selfish thing to do. Now you're fucking up other people's fucking lives because it's all about you.
Do you know some guy jumped off the Empire State Building recently? There's a young guy who's gonna jump off the GW.
Do they ever make it to the ground? Don't they usually get blown into a ledge? Like the Empire State Building starts off at the top, very slim, and then has big ledges that come out.
Yeah, but that'll kill you.
Oh yeah, it'll kill you. But it's not like you're gonna hit the sidewalk.
Well, that's everyone's goal, to be the first guy to hit the sidewalk.
Yeah, good luck.
I'm too busy throwing fucking pennies off the top.
I love winging pennies off of there.
I'm fucking a big fan of that.
Hoping it goes through someone's head.
Absolutely.
And you watch,
Some savage.
Then, you know.
What?
Then you watch Mythbusters and realize it doesn't work.
It works.
Yeah?
Yeah, it
works. People just go like, ow. They'll just go, ow, fuck.
I saw that Mythbuster, by the way. I know it doesn't work.
They say it'll go, yeah, because the rumor was it would go right through your head and come out like your taint.
Right.
That's what they say, but
right.
Apparently, no, not so much.
Here's a quote. Thanks, Danny. Weaver actually saw him land, Palmer said. As a believer in Christ, you have to sit there and pray for the man. You don't even know him, but think about what he might have been going through, and you're hoping that his family or whoever he has can somehow fathom what he did. As far as myself, it was an eye-awakening scene. Even if I had a bad day on the mound, it's nothing compared to what he just did.
What, trying to compare a bad day on the mound to jumping off of a fucking roof in Manhattan and splatting on a sidewalk. Relax.
Walking 10 guys in one fucking
games. I had a bad outing.
Not the same thing as your family not able to identify you until the fucking dentist shows up.
Kind of like the skipper coming out and taking your ball, and then you jump from fucking 40 stories up.
All right, anyway, so that's the old hotel. So, all right, so you got ready for the date with Taylor Vixen, Penthouse Pet of the Year.
Yeah.
And then what? Where are we?
Well, we're hanging out.
Well, did you pick her up?
We went...
you meet her there?
Met her at the restaurant.
Okay.
Met her at the
restaurant. What was she wearing?
Restaurant. A very nice little black, dress number thing.
A hazmat suit.
Yes, I'm known as a secreter. she was wearing a very nice, black number with the nice, her breasts nice and pushed up.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, together.
She was showing off the goods,
those nice big breasts and the diamond and gold, penthouse key dangling in her cleavage. Very lovely.
Mm-hmm.
And she saw me walk in. I went up to the receptionist and whatever they're called, hostess. And asked my reservation. And I heard, Anthony. And I turned around, and there she was. Big arms opened up, comes for the big hug and kiss and everything. Mm-hmm. Like, oh!
What are you thinking, Jimmy? Jimmy's got something.
No. I love this one. I love Anthony. Because I know when Anthony's in those modes, he talks like baby boy Anthony. He gets very sweet. And he probably went, hi! And was very cute. Anthony was probably very cute last night. How are you?
You're an asshole!
His shoulders go up.
Yeah, he gets very cute. I'm okay. Anyone that doesn't know Anthony, never seen Baby Boy Anthony. He's a very sweet.
Baby Boy.
But it's very sweet. It's a very nice side of Anthony.
You suck.
He gets very cute with, like, Anthony's not a dick to women. Anthony's very nice to women, believe it or not.
I am at their beck and call, as a matter of fact. It's probably my one of two weaknesses in life. That and booze.
Well, it's because he's all sweet at first, like, oh, don't you look pretty?
Oh.
And then you fucking fast forward 8 drinks on fucking spooks. Driving like motherfuckers.
Doesn't take that many drinks.
It's true.
It's like, excuse me, waiter.
That's after the first ginger ale.
when the Mexican comes with the water.
Surprised you didn't swim over here. Cheers.
Coincidence, the wet brag brings the water. Wet brag?
Yeah, it's a wet brag.
Really?
That's all right.
That's all right. You dated a fucking pet of the year. Whatever you say, it's fine.
So you got a big hug. She brought a friend, right? That was the rumor going around Twitter yesterday.
A girl did show up.
All right.
Later on.
Was she a pig or was she good looking?
No. Very, very hot.
Was she a penthouse, like, throwaway?
No, I don't think she was a throwaway. I think it's like... I think she was a little nervous.
Yeah.
At, you know, hey, here's some fucking dopey radio asshole.
You're a selfish guy.
I don't want him raping me.
You're a real selfish guy, man.
That's right.
You could have brought one of your friends.
Absolutely.
She's bringing a friend.
I'm not going to bring a friend. Fucking cockwalker. I'm not bringing a cockwalker.
You're hoping for the...
Yeah.
For the menage?
Oh, yeah.
Well, who wouldn't?
I would have just sat at the end of the table and not said anything until the friend showed up. I would have been very quiet. I would have said nothing on your date. Could have helped the brother out.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not cheating if it's for the radio.
That's true.
That's right.
So how long were you together before the friend? Like, what happened? You sat down and you started talking?
Started talking.
Wait, Ant, the phone calls are coming in.
Are they?
Yeah. I don't want to miss any of these fine fucking phone calls today. Jack in South Carolina. Jack.
Hey, did you sweet talk her like you were the blackjack dealer? Pussy, please.
No, I didn't say pussy, please.
Right off the bat.
Pussy, please. And it was a deal where she was drinking and didn't want
wow, what's
to,
her poison?
Didn't want to drive.
What goes with Vicodin?
There was some kind of a rum thingy.
Let it be known, I don't know what Brazilian fucking does in her
rum thingy
in her private life. So. Little joke for the radio.
I didn't detect any drug use.
That's good,
which was good. But it was some responsible drinking.
Vodka, you said?
Rum.
Oh, rum, you said.
Some rum drink that was going on at the Brazilian joint, mm-hmm. Brazilian meat joint,
mm-hmm.
And we had some. We had a lot of meat.
I told you, man. That's a brave move. I know that's where she wanted to go, but fucking taking a first date to a meat joint like the Brazilian place is insane.
Yeah,
you can't say no. As much as you're trying to control your...
I would say no a lot.
But even when you say no a lot, you're still eating 2 pounds of meat by the end of your meal, right?
Until deliciousness came by, and then you got to say yes.
Even though you were trying to be cool and not eat a lot, how much meat do you end up eating there?
Honest. Probably a nice plate full of meat.
Right. And that's with you trying to say no.
Well, I was saying no to probably a good 50% of the people that came by with their meat.
Did you have the paddles?
Steak. Paddles.
The red and green paddles?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. You put it up the color after you're done with the salad bar thingy.
Mm-hmm.
And you flip it, and here come the meat.
How great was the salad bar?
It was good.
You could go there just...
Sushi.
It's not just salad. They have... Yeah. Pretty much anything you could imagine.
Sushi appetizer.
That by the time you sit down with your salad, you don't even need the meat anymore.
No, it was good. And the guy comes over and goes, now you have the salad bar, but take it easy. Take it easy.
Mm.
Like, oh, okay. Well, this guy knows something to take it easy at the salad bar. Because then the cavalcade of meat comes.
Yep.
And wow. Really good, though. But a little stressful at first because they give you tongs.
Mm-hmm.
And as they're slicing the meat off, you got to grab it with the tongs and hold it as it comes down on the plate and grab it. And I was like, all I kept thinking is I was going to drop my meat.
Name all the meats that came by.
Oh.
If you can remember.
God, there's a big fucking, like, sirloin.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's the...
sausage.
Yes.
They bring
sausage.
They bring
you
some sausage.
You've got your sausage.
Sausage.
Put in some sugar. A little wine. Yeah, it was prime rib.
Yep.
On there, and all done like well done or well medium rare.
Mm-hmm.
That, and they slice off the piece you mm-hmm. want. Just wonderful.
Yeah.
And I had to keep turning them down. Nothing with bacon on it. I didn't want bacon wrapped stuff. I just was having a lot of the lean stuff. A little pork loin would come by.
Oh,
ooh,
yeah.
How about that? A little short rib.
Oh,
a little short rib. Bam! You got your short rib.
I gotta brag. You know Quinn, my brother.
Oh yeah.
Used to work on Wall Street. Doesn't have to anymore. He's raising kids and I don't know what, fucking playing golf, whatever.
Yeah.
He went there with us, me and my cousins, and Quinn went, and a couple uncles. He fucking never turned his paddle red.
Are you kidding?
Now, you've sat there.
Yeah.
You realize how that's almost impossible, right?
You have to.
Fucking turned his paddle to red and ate everything.
And I made sure I did not keep eating to the point of, oh, my God, I'm so full. So I turned it over.
That's impossible.
Well before I was full. Because,
that's really impossible.
No, because...
You go there to gorge.
You're on. No, not in that situation, you see? I didn't want to be in that situation.
You guys went to a little sushi joint, had a little sushi.
She wanted
meat.
I'm taking her for meat. She wanted meat. I'm slipping her some meat.
She's taking her to the Carnegie Deli.
Yeah, get her some liverwurst and head cheese. Watch her vomit.
Go Dutch. Be a chiseler.
Chiseler.
Or complain about the price of everything. Everything that she orders, ask the waiter, how much is that going to run me? Fucking cheapskate.
Yeah, she actually asked it when the check came. Oh, you want to split that? Okay, Ralph.
You should have. You should have taken out your reading glasses and a little calculator and calculate how much she owes in front of her.
It's a tip calculator.
Right.
No.
Be an old fucking Jewish woman with her friends.
Sit there. Exactly. That's 12% or something.
There's nothing better than watching a bunch of old Jewish women fucking figure out how much they owe on a lunch tab. Oh my God.
We had a good dinner and then decided it was time to hit the meatpacking district.
That was for
a little nightlife. Well, yeah, it's dinner. What the fuck do you want? You're there, you're
any
slicing, you're eating
Jimmy?
Meat, you're, we're talking. We're getting
I don't
want to
miss
other.
Anything here, so.
We're getting
are we
to
moving
know
on
each
from
other.
The meat joint?
How long were you there for?
It was a getting to know each other thing. Probably 2.5 hours.
Oh, that's a while. Till about 11. What time did the friend show
there's
up?
There's a lot of talking. I don't even remember.
She showed up to the restaurant.
Yeah. I don't remember, though.
So you have to buy her meat, too?
Well, yeah, I have to buy a little meat.
You had to buy her meat.
So where did the girl...
I know what to ask, because they were there 2.5 hours. Yeah. Did you get a little closer?
Do you mean physically, or do you mean psychologically and spiritually?
Well, whatever you want to tell us there.
Well, we got to know each other a lot better. You know, real know each other.
She
not,
actually...
Not just, you know, what's on your penthouse thing. We talked
about
black people a lot.
Does she like him or hate him?
I'm not going to say anything about that wonderful, sweet girl. But we did talk race.
We've had a lot of bimbos in here. And Taylor Vixen seemed like, you know, seemed a lot cooler than most.
She's,
and she seems like she could carry on a conversation.
She's a very cool girl. And it's not one of the, those, you
was
know.
There, was
we were
there
talking about her likes and dislikes from the penthouse page, which are completely ridiculous and... You know, written and things like that.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You figure that's all made up.
And she's from Texas, so talked about her, you know, her life in Texas and California, and just getting to know. It's the getting to know each other thing.
Did you figure out who touched her as a child?
I really couldn't figure that out. It could have been one of many people.
Really?
But I didn't really care. I just wanted to be the last in the line. So far.
Someone touched her.
I wanted to be the last horrific touching experience.
She was in full bloom by the age of 8. Someone touched her in her family.
Jesus Christ. She has a good relationship with her family, so...
That's good.
You know,
did you peck her on the cheek or anything at the meat joint?
No, I didn't think that would be a good move.
Okay.
I like the let's kind of really get to know and get some booze in you phase of the whole thing. So after that, it was a hitting the meatpacking district. We went to the beer garden.
Jesus, didn't you have enough meat?
Well. There was no meat where we went. It was the beer garden down.
I would have been so embarrassed if we bumped into each other in the meatpacking district. You saw me in my car.
Hi, I'm with Jimmy tonight.
Yeah, you see me and somebody 6'8 with a blonde wig scraping the inside of my Beamer. What are you doing? Fred needed a lift home.
Just awkward.
I'll be right back, Daddy. I have to go tuck again.
I don't know what you mean.
Yeah, what do you mean,
madam?
Madam with giant shoulders.
Get out, madam. So, where in the meatpacking district? What street is that?
It's, I forgot the street, but it's called the Beer Garden. It's a wonderful outdoor, bar.
Oh, okay.
A bunch of tables. They have, ping pong. They got everything going on there. And it's all heated. It's outdoor, but they got these heaters hung up there, so the whole goddamn place is heated.
Oh, that's pretty
And
cool.
It's underneath that, elevated train line that they made the park.
Yeah,
right underneath that.
Wow.
Yeah. So it was nice. We hung out there. The bartender, very nice guy, made wonderful martinis, lemon drop martinis. And
you know, the two girls.
Some beers. Yeah.
Nice.
And hung out a little more chatting. It got a little more, the conversation got a little more intimate and sexual in nature.
Were any guys being cock blockers or no?
No, some people were looking over.
Yeah.
Like, what is that creep doing with that very attractive girl kind of look?
She looked good.
But, yeah, she looked really good.
Yeah.
She did. She looked really good. So, you know, she's got a very, like, pretty face and everything, you know? You got guys fucking peering over. Get the fuck out of here.
Mm-hmm.
Asshole.
Mm-hmm.
Leave. Smack you.
Yeah.
No, it was fine. And, you know. A lot of chatting, a lot of chit chat going on, and
did you get very? it's just
yeah, problem.
I need Jimmy on this one
because
it reminds me of one of Jimmy's bits that makes me laugh every fucking time he does the bit on stage. I'll just say this: did you get very possessive?
No. What is that? What did you do something
about
being possessive?
Oh, if the girl's cell phone rings?
Right.
Oh, if you're on a first date and her phone rings, look at her.
Oh,
you go, who the fuck is that?
You barely know her, but you say
that could be funny as fuck.
Yeah, you look right at the phone.
Who the fuck is that?
Dad, pick it up.
Yeah. Great.
Will you answer it for her? Who is this?
She's with me now. You've only known her an hour.
What are you doing?
So you weren't possessive when the guys were looking over?
No.
Why are you looking at my girlfriend?
And there was a couple of calls or texts that were going on, but I was getting them too because, you know, people wanted to know what the fuck is going on. And what's her name from Penthouse that brings the girls?
Lainey.
Yeah, I believe Lainey called at one point. I think they were just making sure she was okay.
Oh, really?
They didn't want her murdered. People hear stories, you know.
Sure.
They hear stories about me and think, you know, it's going to be an awful experience or something. But it was very nice.
Got a little bit more intimate, you said?
Yeah, just the conversation got a little more intimate. It was very nice. And we hung out at the bar just chit-chatting. Found out she is coming back in June because she's leaving. She lives in L.A. Mm-hmm. This is a problem.
Oh, I'll be there Sunday.
Oh, really?
Ooh. Maybe I could just...
What the fuck do you... What do you mean?
Just saying, I'll be out there.
You stay away!
Maybe I can gather info and intel for
a little intel?
Check up on her for you.
So why don't you take a trip out to L.A. and go see her?
Before June.
Woody Allen.
I could do that.
What kind of a boyfriend are you?
I could do that. Boyfriend? What? Oh, my God.
Did she even say maybe you could come and see me in L.A.?
Yeah, that's fine. Because
said that?
Here, yes.
She meant Louisiana.
But here... I'm flying to L.A. What the fuck is this? But in June, already planning. Compound.
She's coming to the compound?
Yep.
For what?
Hang out. Wow. Little poolage.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow.
Because who wouldn't love to see her... relaxing by the pool.
Dude, you're going
to
become the new Hugh Hefner, man.
That's what the whole place is about.
And then you have her bring in the other ones.
That's what it's all about.
Next thing you know, you're like the penthouse Hugh Hefner.
Yes.
And you know, penthouse is a little dirtier than
that's my goal.
Right now, you're Hugh Downs.
Hugh Downs. My goal is to have a skimmer that looks like it's had shaving cream squirted into it.
And Penthouse shows a little dirt in their fucking pictures.
Yeah.
Playboy doesn't.
Do.
They used to, not anymore. They
Playboy
got really
doesn't.
Hardcore.
Yeah, they don't have the piss and the
they're trying to tone it down a little bit.
And I think they toned it down a little bit.
Wait, so what happened? We skipped ahead. So you're at the beer garden, and it was getting sexier.
And we're making, because I know she's got to go, you know, on Thursday. That I'm kind of making plans for the next time.
Right.
So that's where I was going with the next time. She said she insisted she take me out to dinner,
mm-hmm.
and we'll go back to the compound and hang out when she comes back. But
wow.
But until then, who knows? I might take a little trip out to the coast. Why not, right?
Absolutely.
You know, I should go out there and just see what the fuck.
Absolutely,
so
you should.
So obviously you caught, like, a little connection with her?
I think there was something there. There was some fun and, you know, a little, well, I'm not sure, a little connection. She's coming in a little later, so, we'll, you know, I'll see what how the overnight ratings were.
Fuck, we should have.
Let me get the overnight.
We should have some kind of fucking, we should have questions.
Don't fuck me up.
We should have questions to see how well she was listening.
No!
Yeah,
I didn't do, here's
do.
What I do though. Here's what I do. And I've learned this since I was a kid with girls. You don't sit there and babble about yourself.
Uh-huh.
You talk, you have a conversation, but you entice them to talk about themselves and comment on what they're saying. Because girls will get very bored if you just sit there and talk about yourself. If you have a common interest or a commonality in where you've lived, things like that, then you could throw your own shit in there. But for the most part, don't just sit there and give these fucking diatribes about your life and fucking bullshit like that, because then it bores the chick. If you're listening to her, so then what she's saying, that works a lot better.
So this is a pointer for all the guys that are going to be going out on a date with a penthouse pet of the
year. Exactly. Any of you tin knockers out there
that get an opportunity to date a penthouse pet of the year.
Right.
Listen to Anthony's advice.
Do you know, yesterday, as a matter of fact, when we sat in this very studio yesterday for the show, I looked out that very window and saw a guy from a company called PJ Mechanical.
Oh, sure.
An air conditioning and heating company. They were changing filters in here yesterday. Don't think it went unnoticed by me. I sat there and looked at this poor bastard with his head poked above the acoustic tile ceiling, replacing filters in air conditioning units.
Yuck.
As I was sitting here thinking, I did that, and now I'm going out tonight with a penthouse pet of the year.
See, anything's possible.
It really is.
Anything's
Fairy
possible.
Fairy tales can come true. It could happen to you.
I think it's really funny that you're acting like this is a story of inspiration to be lauded as one of a tale of heartbreak and sorrow and victory.
Yes, Jimmy.
It's a tale of overcoming the obstacles.
Thank you.
Do brilliant, funny voices and be vitriolic in your humor. And people will like you.
Thank you. Dude. You're absolutely
is this what she was wearing last night?
Let me see. Let me see that picture. No, it was very similar, though.
Okay.
And she had, like, a little thing, because it was a little chilly last night.
Jesus.
So she had a little on-the-shoulder thingy going on.
Oh, wow. Yeah, Taylor Vixen on Twitter.
Yeah.
So... Yeah.
We were laughing our asses off at the tweets that were coming in, by the way. Sitting there... reading some of the tweets and just laughing and laughing about it. It was good. Here's somebody here saying, gotta love Jimmy to bring Ant back to Earth.
No, I'm happy for Anthony, man. That's, I would never cockblock Anthony.
No, I never would even suggest that you would do that.
You know what
would
be funny, though?
Jimmy's a team player.
Like, if you just brought up really serious things, like you got, like, a little too drunk. Like, there's a story in the paper about father charged and infant shaking death. And if you were just like, how the fuck does anybody shake a baby
shake
to death?
A poor little thing. Do you know what the thing was probably thinking right when it was being shook it to death?
Jesus. And she's just looking like, okay, get me the fuck out of here.
What? So when did you guys leave the beer garden?
Left the beer garden. It was probably close to 2:30. They closed the outside beer garden like at midnight because I guess there's an ordinance and they don't want people fucking yelling and waking people up that live 18 blocks away.
Well, it's time for the trannies to go to bed.
Exactly.
That's basically what you're
go
saying.
To bed. So we took it inside to the inside bar, grabbed a table, and had a few more cocktails.
Till what time?
In there till about 2:30 in the morning.
How the fuck do you do it? Are you drunk now?
No. As a matter of fact,
from what 7, 8 o'clock all the way to 2:30 in the morning.
No, from 9. I started drinking at 9 until about 2:30, but I only had beer. I didn't drink anything. I didn't have any shots.
If I only had beer from 9 to 2:30, I'd still be drunk.
Yeah.
You're not drunk?
Nah. I've been in
you
here.
You don't seem drunk.
I've been in here drunk from the night before, and this ain't it.
Yeah, you're fine.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah. Tell us something we don't know. Jesus.
Yeah. Well, some nights. I stopped, unless, you know, a special occasion, but I did stop the during the week drinking, unless I was doing something like this.
This is acceptable. If you were booting heroin, this is acceptable. You're out with her, she's like, look, I want to score a little fucking coke and heat it up and smoke it.
Even Jimmy understands this one.
No, since I've started...
Jimmy understands this one.
Since I've started my workout regimen,
he's not going to question you on this
I have
one.
Stopped the during the week drinking.
Right.
Unless there's a Tuesday date with a penthouse
pet of the year.
Then I'm gonna, you know,
all right.
I'm gonna sit there and teetotal.
You don't have to explain to us. So 2:30, you leave the beer garden.
2:30.
We want to know how this
leave
whole thing
the beer
ended.
Garden. It's back to the original restaurant. Where the parking garage was.
Okay.
And,
where the transportation was.
Yes, the transportation. There was the drop off and, a nice, you know, little, take it easy. Nice little safe home kind
what,
of
a
thing.
A nice little take it easy. What, did
nice
she,
little.
Does that mean she got on her knees?
Yeah, that's exactly what it was. It was on her knees in the street on 49th
isn't
Street.
Isn't that what a take it easy is?
No, that's a how do you do?
Oh, wow. I'm confused. I'm sorry.
How do you do?
I thought that's what you meant by the take it easy.
No, it was a nice take care. I'll see you tomorrow.
Did you desperately grope her?
Yes, I actually did desperately grope her.
Like, please don't leave.
By the parking garage.
It's like fucking Cinderella.
I wanted to drag her off.
Right. You know, at any moment, this dream is coming to an end. So you desperately groped her.
Oh, no, this was
you
just...
You desperately grope a penthouse pet of the year.
Nah, this is just a nice little...
little hug.
Step through the door kind of a thing. And how do you do? And
did you rub...
No, it was a nice
did you
little,
rub chests together a little bit?
There was a little bit of bodily contact.
Mm-hmm.
I'll say that. I don't want to be a kiss and tell graphic guy here on the radio. But we'll see.
Jesus.
We'll see how
in between the lines.
We'll see what she wants to say when she comes in. Because
did you kiss her goodnight?
Yeah.
And it was outdoors.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So somewhere around the parking garage, a little groping happened.
Well, you want to look at security cameras from
sure,
the area?
Why not?
You want to see if there's a security camera?
Hey, we know people. Get your make and mic on
49th
it. I'm sure
Street
it's his fucking
parking garage.
Get your make and mic on it.
Did you like aimlessly shuffle uncomfortably towards her hotel until she indicated that you were not coming upstairs?
No.
Just kind of like I'm kicking the can walk, like your little legs kicking out slowly.
That was the problem, because she had to go back to Jersey because she's got shit to do today, and then she's dropping in here. But she had to go back to Jersey.
What does she have to do in Jersey? Yeah. She's a penthouse pet of the year.
She should live in the Big Apple.
There's shit happening in the Big Apple.
It's the Big Apple.
I'm not going to intrude with that kind of question or anything, but, I accept it. It was a great, fun night.
Mm-hmm.
And,
So there's no reason to smell your fingers this morning?
Smells like
meat.
Sausage. And
have you had your first meat shit yet?
No, I haven't taken a meat shit.
Oh, my God. Wait till that fucking decides to show its ugly head.
Yeah?
Oh.
But I was being good. I was like, I wasn't eating like fucking tons of it. I know. I didn't want to fuck up, I had a good cholesterol count. I didn't want to fuck it up.
Well, Bill in Boston.
Hello, Bill.
Bill, go ahead. He's on to something here. Go ahead, Bill.
Anthony, you're already my hero. But
thank you.
You've already got one Playboy chick. Now, this is a potential penthouse chick. We need you to get a hustler chick, and you go into the fucking Hall of Fame, my friend.
A swank also.
You might, yeah, and a Bigums.
Exactly. Yeah, no, I don't want a Bigums.
Yeah, but we
over
want
50.
No, I don't want a Bigums.
And over 50, yes.
And he's already had Puerto Rican inches.
We need one from the Bigums magazine.
Yeah.
And the over 50, yeah, Bill, right on.
Well, she was in Hustler. She was also in Hustler.
Wow.
She was a cover girl of Hustler, but I think you need separate girls from each magazine to do the trifecta.
Yeah,
can I tell you about the penthouse girl?
Honcho. I also got a gentleman from Honcho, which is wonderful. Uncut. Docking. It's wonderful.
You fucked who?
No, I said, did I ever tell you about the penthouse girl I fucked?
Oh,
no.
There's a reason for that.
Mm-mm.
It never happened.
Oh, Jimmy.
It never happened. Very jealous.
Exactly.
I fucked a girl from Highlights once.
Let's say hi to Ball Washer.
Yeah, no. Gallant watched.
Gallant just wept. I mean, I'm tongue my balls at knife point. Well, Goofus sucked my asshole.
Goofus
is a goer. Goofus will lay your head back over the bed and
of
fuck your throat while Gallant,
Goofus.
Gallant chides him.
Gallant makes sure he swallows every drop. Goofus gets it all over his face.
Goofus makes a cum master.
Ball Washer, what up?
Ball Washer.
Anthony, did you get to stick it in her fart box?
No, I unfortunately, I did not get to stick it, as you say, in her fart box.
Did you at least get to see her turd cutter?
Well, in pictures.
Well, we all
pictures,
done that.
But I know.
We've all done that.
Yeah, but you know what? Oh, thank you, Danny.
You get to see where the poo comes out?
No, not live. That's... There we go. There's... Aw, look.
You should have that picture on your iPhone while you're eating meat.
I should have went to show her a picture and just go, have that as my fucking like wallpaper.
You know, I like this picture of you the best.
Just her asshole picture.
So wait, what did she have on last night? I want to see a picture of what she had last night.
Aren't there pictures?
Let's say hi to Sean in Georgia. I couldn't find any.
Let me see if I got any on my telephono.
Sean, Georgia, what's up?
Hello, Sean.
Hey, I thought you said last week that you could only drink during the week if it was sunny outside. Now you can also drink if there's a date?
Yeah. As a matter of fact, I can drink whenever anything's going on during the week.
I think dating pen of the year counts as a sunny day.
But, yeah. But you know what? I'm not gonna cut myself off, when I got a date like that. Why would I cut myself off? But if I'm just sitting around at home is what I'm talking about. I'm not gonna sit there like I would, run downstairs to the bar, grab a beer, and come back up and sit and just watch TV drinking beer. So, you know, I just drink water. That's my weekdays now at home.
What did you wear? Just a regular,
No, I had nice clothes on. They're in my bag over there. I had nice, kind of a design, kind of, t-shirt underneath a Armani, button-down shirt. Ooh. And, some nice, dress jeans. Ooh. Yeah.
Jordache?
And, very nice, shoes also, not my normal combat boots. Now I'm, you know, again, dressed like a militant from Cuba.
Back to the young Fidel Castro today. Yeah.
And, of course, no hat. I had my hair nice and gelled and full and follicled. It was wonderful.
I want to see what she had last night. Is there a picture on her Twitter?
I'm trying to pop something up, but I think...
Well, we'll take a break. We'll find the pictures. And
this is, again, very dark picture, but
she's very cute.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She had a very cute, very girl next door-ish look, which
very,
I like. I don't
very
like
pretty.
I don't like that whole yeah, that's very nice.
Holy mackerel.
I don't like that whole like if you're gonna be in Penthouse, that it's a plastic girl.
Right.
You know, with the fake tits, the fake bleach blonde hair,
right.
The feet that look like they've been in high heels forever, so they're all fucked up.
All fucked up. Right.
She has very, very cute feet, by the way.
I'm not a feet guy.
I'm not a feet guy either. I've said this many times.
You notice the feet, though.
Part of the whole package.
Yeah.
It's part of the whole package. Like, if she looks like she does and then had big talons, it's kind of a turnoff.
I just think there's so many other things to look at before you look at the fucking feet.
But, you know, you do a head-to-toe, and you want to make sure there isn't some big fucking, you know, Sasquatch thing going on.
A big foot corn?
Yeah, something like that. You don't want talons.
No.
Doesn't bother me.
Yeah. Well, it wouldn't bother me. It wouldn't be like, it's not a deal breaker. But it's nice when you don't have to deal with that.
I wouldn't care if her feet had pictures of Magic Johnson on them. Fucking still lick them.
It's like it doesn't have his blood on.
Yeah. I like when a girl's feet stink a little.
Really?
Not terribly, just a little. And they go, like, smell them.
I don't mind a little, a little knowing they're a human kind of stuff going on. Because girls just smell good naturally. They throw off a nice fucking pheromone.
Sometimes.
I like it.
Sometimes you get a good whiff of asshole. And you're like, that's... Oh,
Steve Carlisi. Congratulations.
Keeps you honest, asshole. Right, Jimmy? Keeps you honest, though. Like, woo.
Keeps you honest?
Oh, boy. Like, woo.
It levels the playing field is what it does. It levels the playing field. It's like, wow, I thought you were so much better.
It's like, goddamn, I thought fucking girls are supposed to smell nice always. You fucking get a whiff of that every once in a while. That'll fucking wake you up. Let's take a break. Very good. Anthony's date went well, and Taylor Vixen will be in here in a couple hours to say hi before she heads out and back to L.A.
Back to L.A. There she goes.
I think Jay Moore's.
Yeah?
I think Jay Moore's coming by, our old friend. He's playing Gotham this weekend, so.
Yeah?
I think we should sell that fucking Gotham comic club out old school for Jay Moore.
Certainly.
Let's do that.
I'm looking forward to my part on Gary Unmarried, too.
What? When?
Not happening. Just wanted to see what that sounded like coming out.
You could probably score something there.
No, I couldn't.
With Jay coming in.
It's network television.
Just,
doesn't work that way.
You just say, hi, I'd like to do the show, and he'll go, I'll put you in touch with people that won't do it.
Let's pressure him today. He does a radio thing on the show. I mean, we're perfect for this.
I'll just
does
he?
Yeah.
I'll just do scenes.
He does radio stuff on Gary Unmarried, so we're perfect for this.
Yeah.
Bring us in to do some radio shit on Gary. Hey, BJ Penn will be here in, a half hour. So why don't we take a break so we can do a few other things?
I'm going to fucking arm bar him.
Really?
Oh,
good luck
you?
With that.
And hope that works out well. I would love to see that. He doesn't budge an inch when you do it. And then just clobbers you over the head with a big fist. Drives you in the ground like a nail. Like rock.
I was just kidding.
Oh, sorry. I actually had a fantasy about you getting pummeled.
Who would you use arm bar? I mean, you saw a big tent in the front of my pants.
Not be surprised.
Let's do a quick break so we can do other shit before BJ Penn gets in here. Opie and Anthony. Yeah, it's Whip 'Em Out Wednesday. I like that production. It's hard to do the fucking Whip 'Em Out Wednesday when you do morning radio, but we don't want to let that thing go.
That sucks.
We give that bit to you guys. You guys continue it out there. We see the WOW stickers. And for the new listeners, maybe we have some new listeners. I don't know. Who the fuck knows? I don't know how the satellite radio works with ratings. I don't know how many fucking people are listening.
You just gotta
depend. They say we're doing well, but who knows?
Yeah, you just got to depend on seeing the stickers out there.
Right.
But that's the only way I could gauge it.
But for the women, you see those WOW stickers on the cars. Yeah, that basically means that guy wants to see some boobs.
Yeah.
Okay.
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 Okay. Okay.
Terrific.
Okay. And how do they get their WOW stickers, Danny? That is definitely happening.
Tell them how to get them.
Yeah, they could just send a self-addressed stamped envelope to WOW Stickers. Attention, Opie and Anthony, 1221 6th Avenue, New York, New York, 10020, 36th floor.
And where is that fucking info if they want to find it? Because they don't have good memories. They're driving right now. Like, how am I going to remember that?
Yeah.
Can we put it on the pad data today, or is that too many characters?
It's like too much.
Too much?
There's too many characters in this room, if you want my opinion.
Too many characters, like Mr. Diamond.
We got WOW promos running, and I'll figure out a place to put it.
Yeah, all right. I guess we got to get a website or something. It's been a little too long without a website.
It's mind-boggling.
True.
It really is.
Why would we have a website? That internet is a fad.
Believe me, if I had 1 hour with you two, you both would listen. Just.
What?
No way.
yeah, it's only, 2010. Why have a website?
I don't have one either.
You have a website?
I did, but it was the company stunk that was running it, and I'm getting a new one made by the same guy that's doing my app.
Yeah, I got a guy that wants to do an app.
We need an app.
I got a guy that's doing an app for wants to do one for me.
Yeah?
Well, we have to get individual apps. We got to get a show app. We got to get, I don't know.
I want an app.
I want someone to come up with a very creative app for me. Not a basic, stupid app. I want something different.
Yeah?
Yeah. And then we need a show app.
An app. I want one, too. I need an app. Everyone needs an app these days.
Well, yeah, apps are taking over the world.
You don't even really need a website these days, but...
You do need it less. Like, honestly,
you need a home base.
You know, I
49,000 on Twitter. It's like I can talk to that many people immediately, or say now the number. It's like, there's other ways to communicate.
Yeah.
Yeah, I get it. Well,
we should have the whole fucking bill of goods.
Anthony, I got a guy.
Yeah?
I got a guy.
Jimmy's app could be ready within like 24 to 48 hours.
Stop it.
And he's going to Twitter immediately when it's out there. Yeah.
Put me in contact.
And all it is, everything on my app is just a photo of me. And it's gonna be a $28 app.
$28, and you click on it and just see a photo of you.
Yeah, but like when I smile, the tooth gleams like a star.
Ooh.
It's worth every penny.
That's good.
It sure is.
I figure if I just sell one.
Maybe if I have an app that... Because your app has to give something to people that they can't get anywhere else. That's the trick.
I have a few things in my app.
So what do you do? You could have things that people could get other places, and it's kind of consolidated into the app. But then also, there's got to be something there that they can't get anywhere else.
That's right.
I do have that.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
so why?
Do not tell until it comes out, right?
Oh, it'll be a big surprise.
Oh, Jimmy, you click on it and get AIDS.
Yes.
Here's something you can't get just anywhere.
Yeah.
A communicable disease.
You click on the weenie.
All right, why don't we move on for now? Fuck.
Ooh.
We got BJ Penn coming in here in about 15 minutes. So.
Well, I hope he's not still here when your chick shows up.
Uh-oh.
That's going to be a rough one.
He could
women love fighters.
And he could just do whatever he pleases.
He wouldn't have to. He could just charm her. You know he's a married man, but yeah. It doesn't matter.
Oh, that's good. Married man, are you?
Married man, are you?
He's married, so that's good.
Yeah.
And then but he's a charmer, really?
And he I'm saying
not
he was just
a muscle head.
I'm saying he could just charm her. He wouldn't have to beat you up or do anything alpha male. He could just probably charm her. Yeah, you know, I was UFC champ and had a little rough, you know.
Well, I'd hate to have to take him down a notch. Yeah, that's going to happen.
That's right. He would explain fighting Machida. You could say, you like Popeye. Funny people, we really do have nothing. If they don't have a good sense of humor, we're fucking doomed.
That's why it's good when people say women like a guy with a sense of humor. And it usually comes up like first. Guys are always asked, and they're like, oh, girls, I noticed, you know, the face or legs or ass or tits or whatever. And girls are always, I like a guy with a nice sense of humor.
That's the first half. You see, you're forgetting the comma. That's, I like a guy with a nice sense of humor, but not to fuck.
Yeah.
To drive me to a real man's house.
To drive me to get a good fucking.
Yeah, I like a man to make me laugh while I'm going to get a real cock stuck in me.
We got Greg in D.C. Greg!
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 Hi.
I was hoping that Anthony would be the one who would develop the app that would help men over 40 detect women under 20 who have daddy issues.
Oh, now that would be an app.
That is a useful app.
Yeah,
that would be a useful app.
A lot of you young guys have fucked yourselves, though. Not you, sir, but a lot of young guys. A lot of women don't necessarily have daddy issues, but young guys just don't make enough money. They don't. Yeah, it does, but they're just fucking, they don't do the right thing.
They certainly don't. You know what it is?
You don't need money to get a younger girl with fucking cool daddy
issues. That shows responsibility, though. I'm saying you don't have to have daddy issues.
I was a magnet for daddy issues.
Broads with daddy issues. I was a magnet for that shit for many years.
Yeah.
What the fuck? Then you realize, whatever.
You just don't want to, you don't want to act like, like an asshole or too cool for the fucking room. It doesn't work.
I talk to my girl like this because she's younger. She'll say something. I'll go, now, is that what we talked about?
Oh, my God. Oh, I'm sure she loves that.
Now, what did we say about that?
Oh, you say it just like that, right? Oh, my God. Would she be pissed?
And if you want
to smack you in your face.
No, but we were arguing once and I did Edgar, who nobody on the show knows, but Edgar is one that she...
Edgar's a great
you don't
character.
Understand. It's not even a joke. The hatred for Edgar. She's like, I am afraid I'm going to bite your face when you do Edgar.
She does not like Edgar.
No, because Edgar's selfish and he has a little mouth and he wants his teeth licked because they're dry.
You want to do Edgar for us?
Jimmy makes a little asshole mouth.
You want to do Edgar for us?
I'm tired. Lick my teeth. They're dry.
His mouth gets like a little bunghole with teeth.
He
purses his lips.
Yeah, but it's like he's
free. I'll be a fan of Edgar's.
I really think
Chip,
you should
not so
be.
Much, but Edgar I think I can handle.
Edgar hates Chip.
Give me a little more Edgar.
Edgar has convinced Chip that she's trying to poison him. Do you understand that?
Give me a little more Edgar.
She'll offer. She'll say, why don't you have some of this? And Chip gets very, why do you want me to eat that? Who told you to tell me that? It's a whole thing
Edgar
going on.
Did.
Yeah, Edgar.
And give me a little more Edgar.
That must be some fucking household.
Do you know how many times I've heard, I just want my boyfriend?
Give me a little Edgar.
You're supposed to do your duties. Lick my teeth.
Has she ever licked your teeth?
To shut me up, yeah. But most times she's like, I want to fucking bite you, Edgar. She talks to him as Edgar. He's very self-centered.
Yeah.
He walks really slow.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, god damn. Keep your mouth, you're gutter trash.
Holy shit.
Because if she curses, I'll always tell her, you talk like a woman from Lower Stock.
Do you have multiple personalities? I just gotta ask.
No.
Holy
you
shit.
No, but she fucking
hates these characters come
Edgar.
Out. Oh, and they're very... They're very much different.
She hated Chip for a while, but then Chip grew on her.
Yeah.
But Edgar...
She really hates Edgar.
It's for real.
Yeah.
Right. Like, it's like, she's like, you don't understand. I want to fucking... She's like, sometimes I have to gauge
how worth is the fight we're going to have if I fucking hit you in the face?
Edgar. Edgar's an ass.
Yeah, Edgar Mellencamp.
I like Edgar.
Yeah, Edgar fucking rules.
Let's go to Mike in Pittsburgh. Mike, fuck you, fuck your Penguins, fuck
Mike?
Crosby. Goddamn fucking NHL playoffs start tonight.
Just pay attention, Opie. You'll see what happens in the end.
I need a fucking team for the playoffs. What do you suggest? I can't go Penguins. I can't do it.
Well, we'll see what happens.
I might have to go Flyers for the in-laws.
Yeah, you probably
might have to do Flyers. What do you got, Mike?
You're two-city guy.
Hey, I wanted to know how long after the kiss goodnight did you get back to the hotel and whack your bag?
No, I did not whack my bag.
It's a good question, though.
Last night.
Why not?
I bet you leaked enough pre-cum in his fucking pants. I bet you his cock looked like a marionette. Working his ankle.
You think there were a lot of jizz in his underpants when he got home?
It was stringy and leaking.
Did you spill jizz when you hugged her goodnight?
It was like the alien mouth attacking Sigourney Weaver.
Did you spill warm jizz into your underpants, Ant?
No.
When you embraced?
It was getting much too late
to
do
anything
but go to sleep.
Did you pop a boner during the
pop a boner
during the date? The
Let
big
me
date
think
with
if
the penthouse
I
pet of the year.
Popped a boner.
Yeah.
I was plumped for most of the evening. Just at a nice plump phase where it would have looked impressive but not looked like I was trying.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
So, and you want that just in case anything happens, spur of the moment.
Well, I have a lot more questions to ask you, but fucking BJ Penn is outside our studio. We should get him right in.
Yes.
Hey, Mikey, thanks for the phone call and whatever. Good luck to your Penguins. What can I tell you? My fucking team's playing goddamn golf once
Good
again.
Good luck.
We've made the playoffs, what, 4 times in the last 15 years? That's terrific. Why the fuck am I still spending money on the Islanders?
I don't know.
You want to say hi to BJ Penn or what?
Yeah. Certainly.
BJ!
There he is.
What's up, brother?
How's it going, guys?
How you doing, man?
How's it going?
Great.
How you doing?
Hi, man. Yeah.
How's it going?
All right. We could plop down
What's up, BJ?
Over there.
We're all big fans there, BJ Penn. Who's got a new book out?
I tried to shake his hand like a man, like I wanted to make sure I had a good grip.
Wait,
like that would make us equals.
How'd that work out
wait,
I should have just curtsied in a skirt.
Who had the best handshake there, BJ Penn? Who had the strongest? Who had the man handshake?
I think you had the strongest.
Yeah, of course. I know I did.
Yeah.
I screwed up. I went to grip, but he grabbed just my fingers and shook
it. Yeah, I got the tip of the hand myself. I did a little fucking
you make
lady,
sure you get
how
right
do you
in there.
Do a handshake.
You show him who's boss, right?
I look like a faggot.
We saw you on Fox yesterday taking down that anchor. We were very happy to see that. Do you know that guy or no?
I just met him that day. He's pretty tough, though.
Yeah, is he?
He's pretty
really?
Strong. He surprised me.
That was surprising just to see him like volunteer to do that.
And he wanted more. He didn't want to stop.
A lot of guys don't do this. Tie was flapping around. He's in a suit and tie, for God's sake.
Now he'll think every anchor wants that. He'll do it to Katie Couric.
Be nice to see.
We're just mad because one of our guys wanted to do that. Where's Mars? Mars was like, look, I'll fucking do a little something with BJ Penn.
Oh my
Where's
God.
Mars?
Mars has
been bragging about his skills for a long time.
Mars likes to think he's a martial artist. He's got some skills. He trains. Here he comes.
Yeah.
He trains in the
Mars.
Art of,
BJ? Now that BJ Penn
you got
is in
me
studio,
wrong. I said Frankie Edgar.
Now that BJ Penn is in studio, why don't you fucking
why don't you mouth off
right to BJ Penn while he's in studio there, Mars.
Now he's got a manly handshake.
Mars,
right?
Would you take BJ Penn on?
Take him on?
A little sparring. And hopefully he fucking cracks your whip.
He's trying to think of how do I say no without actually saying. He wants to act like he's backing off for other reasons. Just say no.
Look at the sweat on his fucking forehead.
I take on some comparable dudes where I go. So.
Oh, don't even start.
Hope BJ Penn fucking breaks your windpipe.
I'm sure he would. You know, but I'm just...
Where Cobra Kai Dojo?
No, that's Edson Carvalho.
Oh, okay.
So do you get people trying you wherever you go? Like, you know, guys that want to see you? Because it's almost like they don't expect to win. So it's like if they beat you, they win. If they lose, so what?
Maybe when I was younger, you know, but now not as much. Everybody just kind of, you know. Well, I'm usually at home in Hilo all the time, so
yeah.
a bunch of friends or people I went to high school with. But
yeah,
now that I've been doing it for so long, they're just like, oh, that's what he does.
They know better.
You're a small guy. Like, you're a small guy than I thought. What, like 155 now?
Yeah, I know. I'm about 170 right now.
What did you fight at?
Like, 155, but we end up cutting some water before the fight, you know,
wow.
Just kind of sweat it out.
That's a lot of fucking water to cut, Jesus.
Yeah, it's amazing to me what these guys do in weight. Like, you fought Machida, right? And how old were you? Like 190 when you fought him?
185.
Holy 185, crap.
And then he fought 30 pounds lower.
That's crazy.
How much can you put on in a day? Like, when you cut weight, how much can you put on in a day?
I probably put around anywhere from 7 to 10. It just depends. Wow. Everybody's different.
How do you do that? With water?
Yeah, I just kind of put on a sweatshirt and kind of lie down by a heater or by
cut weight.
Going and kind of just sweat
that
out.
Sounds so uncomfortable.
Is that how you lose the weight?
Yeah, that's
is hard. It hard to fight when you're dehydrated?
Yeah, that you gotta right after that you make the weight and then put all the electrolytes back in and get ready because you gotta get all those salts back in.
How long do you have between like weigh in and the fight?
Little over 24 hours.
Wow.
So that's why some people try to cut 20 pounds like that and see them go back in and they got a good 1 or 2
you're
minutes.
You're killing yourself, yeah.
Yeah, Bobby said, my friend Bobby, he's a big fan, he said Lesnar can cut that kind of weight. Like, you know, he can go from like 285 down to 265 for the weigh-in and then right back up for the fight.
Easy, huh?
Jeez, that's
what an athlete right there, Brock Lesnar.
It makes you heavier. It makes you, I guess, a harder guy to deal with. But, you know, you lost the belt, for anyone that doesn't know, they said it's one of the biggest upsets in UFC history. I mean, nobody expected Edgar to win that fight. Here's what I was surprised at, like, because you're an amazing jiu-jitsu fighter, and it was, the whole fight was pretty much standing. Why did everyone that night seem to stand up?
But I guess, you know what, you get caught trying to put on a show for the fans.
Really?
Out there.
Huh.
You know, definitely. I like to box too, you know, but, you know, things just went the way they did. It sucks, man.
Oh, shit.
Wow, okay. So what happened? Like, did you realize at one point when we were watching the fight and we're like, are you going to lose this fight? Cause you couldn't really tell where it was going. Was there a point in that fight where you were like, I think I'm going to lose the fight or I have to do something really, really drastic here?
I think I'm going to lose the fight, but I was thinking, man, I got to finish this guy off. You go to the decision, you know, it's like rolling the dice and you don't want to, something you don't even want to play around with. But, you know, I kept trying and, you know, I ended up getting fatigued after a while and Frankie was still there and went to the cards.
Were you, had you trained enough for the, I mean, like, cause like, Liddell got, you know, Chuck is Chuck, so he would, you know, enjoy the life a little bit. And then it kind of becomes harder, the more famous you get, to discipline yourself and make yourself. Did you find that at all? Like, you know, like you had this great life. It's all of a sudden it's hard to get up and go to the gym as much or?
No. I've been through that a few times throughout my career, but I trained, I prepared, I got ready for the fight. And, you know, now it's just all, what do I do? What do I do next? You know, now it's time to get back on the horse and do it again.
What was the first thing, like, when they said and knew, like, when that word knew came out of Bruce Buffer's mouth, you knew he had won. What are you thinking when you realize you've lost the belt? Like, do you have a thought or you none?
Yeah,
or?
It was just a real irritating moment. Yeah, it's just I didn't want to sit there and say anything and take away anything from Frankie's win. You know, I just, you know, give him his shot I'll come back another day.
When are you going to have a chance, you think, to get that back?
Well, actually, the first 2 days ago, I was just sitting there. I was like, you know, let's give the UFC a call. Throw me in with any top contender. I want to do this in the next 6 weeks.
And wow.
Get back. And then the UFC called us. They said, no, we want you to a straight rematch. It was a controversial
fight. Oh, wow,
fight.
Okay.
We want to do a straight rematch.
Was it controversial, Jim?
I think to take a champion's belt, I mean, you know what I mean? It's like when Forrest Griffin beat Rampage, I thought that he should not have taken the belt because he didn't beat a champ bad enough to take his belt, I thought. Is that what you mean? Like they felt that he might have even...
Yeah, I think because we actually landed more strikes. We did more things when they went and looked at the compu strike or whatever, and they really, that's the fight they want. They want to put a straight back in the ring against each other.
It is hard on a decision not to go with the champ. A lot of times they do that, unless you got the shit beat out of you, which apparently you didn't. So Yeah, a nice a straight rematch. Wow, that's cool. Okay.
When is that going down, BJ?
I think they want to shoot for somewhere around August.
Nice.
So I wanted to get in the ring and be a little more active, but what can I complain about? I'm
so now, what do you
back.
What do you do, what do you do between now and then? If you were expecting to fight in 6 weeks, just any contender and stuff, what do you do in between now and August?
That's why I want to just start fighting as soon as possible. I'm getting too old to keep starting over from scratch to do these training camps, you know. I want to just kind of get at a high level and maintain it and just start fighting. And I might as well, you know, because I look back, I'm starting to look at it now and it's like the sparring is the same as the fight. I might as well just do the fight. You're getting punched in the head. You're getting the brain damage anyway, you know.
Oh, yeah, you might as well make the money.
Yeah, you might as well.
So you're going to be fighting between now and August then?
Yeah, somewhere in early August.
It doesn't worry you that maybe, you know, God forbid something happens, you injure yourself or...
Yeah, but I got over that.
You know, yeah.
But you're right. It's always there and you're only one punch away from the end every time, so...
Wow.
How sad were you, like, afterwards? Because he cried when he won the belt. I think you said, I looked through a lot of your book, that you cried when you first won. I mean, do you cry when you lose the belt? I mean, I think I would fucking have a moment where I drop the tear.
This time, you know, I've actually lost the belt before, so it's not the first time, but I'm just, like I said, just really irritated. I wasn't crying. I wasn't sad. I just knew that I could do much better than that.
Do you think what Anderson Silva did, because it was like the Gracie Hughes fight, they both pretty much stood up the whole fight. You guys stayed on your feet. And then, you know, and Silva and Maya was really a weird fight. I'm sure you've seen it since. What did you think of that whole thing that happened between him and Damian Maya?
I didn't get to see the fight because I was in the back, just pissed off about what happened to
him. Yeah,
what just happened to me. But I heard the crowd, I heard the reactions of everything going on. And I guess from what I heard, that Anderson wasn't very motivated to fight his opponent. And because right before his fight, Vitor Belfort, right? He was scheduled to face Vitor Belfort. Vitor pulled out. I heard it was a motivation factor. But on the other hand, I can see Dana being pissed. You know, he's trying to do the global expansion. He's trying to move to a new venue. And then his first show he puts on looks something like this. So I think everybody wasn't happy on all sides. I know I wasn't at the end of the day.
He seemed like he wanted to really, like, have you ever had a guy in the ring that you wanted to? Because that went, like, you know, like, sometimes guys will, for a round, you know, beat somebody a little more than they have to before they knock him out because they're pissed off about something. But he seemed like he really wanted to humiliate that guy. Like, there was something going on. Like, he didn't want to knock him down, at least for the first three rounds. Have you ever been in the ring with somebody that you wanted to really, really put it to?
You know, before the fight, maybe I really want to put it to him, but as soon as you step in there, it's all business. And and to me, I think, you know, what can I do to make the ref stop this thing? You know, that's what runs through my head.
So you don't think about, like, prolong this guy's agony a little bit? Because...
No. I mean, faster knockout, the better for me, personally.
It is odd that you'll fight someone 6 weeks after a previous fight. That's something you never saw in boxing. Why is that MMA decides, you know, you could just fight people within weeks of your last fight?
Well, that's a good question. I think, because in boxing, the guys are almost like an entity of themselves. You know, Mayweather and Pacquiao, that's almost like two organizations basically going up and trying to set a deal. You'd never see UFC be able to close a deal with another organization and have them put on a show together. And that's in a sense what it is, you know. But I think in boxing, you remember Muhammad Ali used to do the bum a month and stuff like
bum
that.
Bum a month.
But, you know, I just, towards the, now I'm starting to get a little further on in my career. I've been with the UFC for 10 years, and I just want to stay active until I can't do this anymore.
Mm-hmm.
How do you feel? Like, because there was, you know, Dana's had some strife with certain fighters, and you do at one point, you were involved in a lawsuit with UFC, and then, you came back and you fight for them, and it's like you guys made up, I guess. You thank him in the book. You thank him for, you know, for kind of furthering mixed martial arts and what they've done. But it wasn't a very, like, personal thank you. Do you guys have a good relationship, or is it strictly a business relationship with a, you know?
No, we have a great personal relationship, but it falls apart every month. So, but it comes back.
Is he? Because we know Dana pretty well, but we never dealt with him on a business. Is he a tough guy to do business with? Like, he's a headstrong dude.
He's a businessman. Yeah, he's a He's a real businessman.
Yeah, you don't build what he's built without and be a, like a pushover or
like
somebody
all
that's
your
kinda,
money away.
Right, yeah. Right. Yeah, yeah. So I'm sure he's, well, just say it. You know, he's a prick to work with.
What made you want to do a book? I mean, did you always, what, it's like, do you always want to do a book, or are you just like, fuck, I can raise some money?
Like Jimmy said.
Yeah, exactly. I saw my mortgage, and I'm like, right.
That's a hell of a question, Jimmy.
Everybody kind of, you know, talked to me about doing the book, and after a while, I was like, okay, let's do it. Let's do the book, And now, you know, it's cool. It gives a little insight to the, you know, to the people, who fans of MMA or fighters trying to start out their careers about, you know, it's not just two guys stepping in the cage. What else goes on? The problems with the management, you know, trying to become a free agent, trying to do all those things. And then I can tell my story a little. You know, a lot of people want to say who I am or tell people who I am and say I'm lazy or whatever, this and that, and just hear it from the horse's mouth, you know?
You come from a pretty much, like, your family was not, like, a lot of guys come up, especially in Brazil, a lot of guys are really, really poor. I mean, and you come from a family that's pretty middle class, you know,
Well, I thought you were going to say from a really rich family, private airplanes and yachts.
No. Why, did you have that? I didn't read the whole book.
No, but that's what a lot of people think, you know, but, I mean, I live a good life, yeah, when, you know, there's, if you had food on your table, then we probably live the same life, you know what I mean? So,
well, what motivated you to fight? That to me is almost more impressive. Like, if your family had money, it's like when you're poor, you're trying to get out of a situation where it's either I fight my way out of this or I got nothing. But when a guy has money, it's like it's almost like harder to motivate yourself to get punched in the face.
it's I guess something I love to do, and I guess what do they say? Live to fight, not fight to live. You know, I just live to do this And it's exciting,
enjoy,
man. There's nothing better than, you know, I mean, I could be a tough guy and beat up anybody on the street, but there's nothing better than going up against somebody who's actually been training every day and looking exactly what I do wrong and studying exactly how can I beat this guy. And then when you go in there and beat him, it just gives you a real sense of gratification.
Did you go through a phase where you beat the shit out of people when you were growing up?
Of course.
Oh, that's great.
Of course. I like that.
Of course.
Wait, what's... Go ahead, Jimmy. Well, I was going to ask, because he mentioned training. He's got one of the most amazing videos on fucking... You're the one jumping out of the pool, right, BJ?
That's right.
Holy...
What's that? Yeah, that's
You've
sick.
Never seen him jump out of a pool?
No.
Danny, can you find that?
Does he do it like I do, one step at a time?
How many feet?
Well, it was just 3 feet with the lip.
Just 3 feet? Please. How high the lip? You've never seen this?
Yeah, look at this shit.
I'm going to have to tweet this.
Try doing this.
He jumps out of a pool.
3 feet.
It's a 3-foot pool.
Squats down.
Squats way down.
To his shoulders.
Holy shit. Oh, you actually, wow, you're not using your hands at all.
No.
Wow. I couldn't do that out of the fucking tub.
And who are the guys in the fucking jacuzzi? Like, just sitting there like,
my brothers, yeah.
Oh, they've seen it before, obviously, because I would have been like,
just like, hey,
I would have lost my mind if I saw that live.
Show off.
Yeah, you should reshoot that with a bunch of chicks in there. It'd be much better.
Everybody was, they're like, yeah, how tough is that? He jumps out of the pool and sits into a jacuzzi with five guys.
Dude, that's got to be almost impossible. Have you seen other guys do that?
You know what, it really started a trend, and now they got all these people out here and they're jumping out of pools and they're doing crazy stuff. But then you got to remember, though, it's got to be the pool with the lip, because it can say 3 feet, and you know, some pools are kind of equal to the water.
Right
With that lip, that does make a difference.
Well, it adds maybe four to 6 inches, probably.
It's a different dynamic. You're not just jumping out of water anymore. You're jumping out of water and then you hit air, you know. And
that's pretty awesome.
But I'm not a high jumper. I think it's more that I got flexible legs.
Just power.
I can't even touch the net, you know?
How tall are you?
5'9".
Oh, you're fucking taller than me. I say he's not a big guy. He's fucking 4 inches taller than me.
That's what I was thinking. Look who's talking.
I know.
Jimmy.
I annoyed him as soon as he walked. I'm a mushy twerp.
You suck.
Oh, I really should have my fucking teeth kicked in.
I saw you training there with the dumbbells also. What kind of weight was on that?
No, you know, actually, I don't lift weights anymore. I got involved with Marv Marinovich. And I don't know if you guys know Todd Marinovich from USC and that whole story, but his father is a great trainer. I got involved with him, and we're all about speed now, actually. Speed, explosion.
Wow, really? No weight training?
Not like you think. Now we got this machine where we put weights on it, and we throw one side, and then the weights come in the back, so it's just constantly throwing things off you.
Jesus Christ.
Instead of that
wow.
slow, because
oh, okay.
lifting weights is too slow, and it throws off your nervous system. You're not as you don't have as much dexterity.
Wow.
It really messes you up. I believe he convinced me of that. I believe that now. And
did you train with him this fight? Or you had for a little while, right?
I always.
So it's more practical to mixed martial arts than it is to.
I think the sports in general. He said the way he figured it out is he got to like a 1,100 pound squatter. So I don't know if he was all the way deep. I don't know what the record is, but he got to a high level squat and then he realized, what am I doing? I'm on my heels. No sport are you ever on your heels. You're always on your toes. And from there, he kind of started basing his program off functional
on what you're
movement.
Doing. Yeah. Yeah. Wow. Because I saw some training going on with some dumbbells, and it just makes me want to just call my trainer up and say,
don't bother.
Don't show up.
Yeah.
Just don't show up. I couldn't hand one of those to you with both hands.
Those look like hundreds.
No. No, I don't know what they are. Yeah.
I see it says at least 50 80s. On. But
yeah, it's 50 on each one. He's doing a little lightweight.
That's more than 50, BJ.
No, it's got to be 100. It's 50 on each side.
You know what,
looking
at this stuff now, it's just that's not the good way.
It's not the good
anymore.
Way to do it.
Yeah.
Wow. How do you keep up your? It keeps up your muscle mass though. Doing the other kind of speed training.
Yeah, I guess that's all food.
Yeah, really.
That's all food on the other end. Yeah, and we're doing a lot of strength things. I wonder if we have any of the videos. You want to check?
Try it. Is it hard to keep discipline as far as eating goes? Things like that? Or is there something you God damn it, I want that.
Yeah, it's that battle, man. That's how I started. You know, before I never used to have to cut any weight for the lightweight division. And then because I cut it once, I started thinking, well, I don't have to cut weight. Let me eat everything I can. And
right.
I got fat and I've been battling being fat for the rest of my life now.
I fucking go through periods like where I can work out for a
periods?
Few periods. Yeah, exactly. I should stop right there. You're right. I fucking water weight in my tits.
Don't tell him. We're in front of a real man today, Jimmy. Keep that to yourself.
Who is this? Is this who are you, sir?
Oh, I'm his brother.
Oh, you are his brother. Okay,
it's obviously his brother.
Why did
they look? They look. I like that.
He'll kick your ass.
Yeah, I know he will. He looks like Steve Byrne.
If
Steve Byrne were a man.
Do now, if you want to check it out. Yeah.
Oh, wow. Look at that. Yeah.
That's the kind
just
of workout.
Throwing weight around.
Throwing weight.
Wow, that's fun. What kind of machine is that?
That's called the Bear.
The Bear.
Yes.
Yeah.
The Bears.
Wow.
D-A Bear.
So there's...
Get off me, it's called. is this on your website, bjpenn.com?
No,
so people can check it out for themselves. Okay.
So how much weight is on there about, would you say?
I think there's not too much weight. I would say maybe the 35 or 45 pound plate, but it's just
how fast you could throw it off of you.
Yep.
And so if some guy starts leaning on you, you push. Now you got the muscle and technique to just push the son of a bitch off
you. Yeah, because it's a lot of leverage involved. So if you can get there and do the leverage before the other guy.
Wow.
Yeah, this one.
Never seen anything like that.
No, I haven't either.
Everyone assumes, weight training. And
I find the elliptical helps.
Do you, Jimmy?
This is the kind of stuff we've been
Oh, wow, look at that. Yeah, now you're upside down. Kicking with your legs.
Yeah, there's one of those exercise balls, and he's on his head, on his head and neck. That looks really, it's like he's jogging upside down, but with weight on his feet.
And kicking that weight off.
That looks exhausting.
Yeah.
Wow. That is probably a hell of a workout, though.
Yeah, these guys, they really know what they're doing.
Yeah.
Do you want to retire at any point? And then all of a sudden you're like, now I have to keep fighting because I can't retire after losing. I mean, what do you want to do after this? Because nobody wants to fight when they're 40, 45. I mean,
you're right. I've gone through that retirement issues in my head many a times throughout the last 10 years. But exactly like you said, how can you walk away after? You can't walk away when you're doing good, and you can't walk away if you do bad. You know, you're stuck.
Well, it's got to be hard because now the money the UFC is bringing in, I mean, it's like it's obviously over the last 10 years, the sport has gone through the roof.
Yeah, because you were there during the years where it wasn't as popular. Now it's gotten to this popularity, and you don't want to walk away when, it's at this point.
But how old are you, BJ?
I'm 31.
Oh, so you got a bunch of years left.
I want to push it. I want to maybe go to 35, and then after that, maybe go home and run for mayor or something, and maybe have a fight. I'm doing a bad job. Let's fight it out. The Civic, earnings can go to charity or something.
The mayor comes up and fights. Yeah, why not?
Hey, did you get to see Abu Dhabi while you were there?
I got to see some of it.
I figured you were there just to fight, so it's tough to get out and check it out.
We went about 2 weeks earlier to try to acclimate, and it was pretty cool. You know, we went to the beaches and seen, they got some nice buildings, and it is a desert though. You know, yeah. You never want to forget that. It's a desert, but.
Did the heat affect everybody or no?
Nah, it wasn't too bad. It was actually pretty cool. It wasn't like really hot. It was cool, nice breeze coming through, and
I got a friend that lives over there. He went to the fight actually. He loved it. He was right near the ring. Dana White fucking hooked these guys up big time.
Oh, right.
They
work
for the military.
Anything.
And he goes that he's sick. He's sick of Abu Dhabi because you just can't see women. They're all fucking covered up.
Yep.
And he's like, that's the most frustrating thing about living in Abu Dhabi, that the women are just covered up all the fucking time.
Is there anything they told you, like, hey, don't do this, it's against their customs or anything like that?
Did they warn you?
Well, just talking to everybody, just it all seemed real normal and relaxed, but then you'd look in the newspaper and, you know, like, oh, woman going to jail for kissing somebody in public.
Man arrested for passing turnip.
That's what's confusing about there, because they're trying to kind of westernize it, but they have all these strict rules still.
And then they have alcohol, but it's connected to a hotel, so it's kind of like. And I think you got to have like another ID to kind of purchase alcohol.
Oh my God,
and,
I'd have to get that lickety split.
Well, Dana White had a hell of a time because there are some strict rules.
They had ring girls, but they had to worry about loud music.
They had to worry about the beer intake at the venue. It was all sorts of things going on that it got passed. Obviously.
God, they must have been getting a hell of an event with those ring girls.
Oh, man. Holy, can you imagine?
Some of those guys sitting there just going, oh, yeah.
In America, that's like going to Madison Square Garden and just seeing girls fuck themselves with salami.
Right. It would be
that's the equivalent.
That's gotta be right, Jimmy.
Hey, but you know what? Didn't they build that arena, too, just for that event? I think they built that in like 3 weeks.
Yeah.
It was
amazing, the setup that they had. You know, it was kind of just a bunch of campers where we were, because you just throw the fighters in the back. Who cares about them? You know, but the setup they had in the front, that was unbelievable.
So I guess they'll keep fighting out. They're not gonna build that. But then again,
they own part of it now.
That's what I heard.
The Abu Dhabi government, or the company that works with the government, I think picked up 10% of the UFC.
But aren't they more fans of it like that? I heard they have no control over. Sorry, I keep putting my foot where BJ's kicking his out. I don't want it to come off as aggressive. it's like they have no say over it, though. It's like if Dana, you know, or he wants to do something.
Yeah, I could see something like that.
I think that's why Dana was so upset about the Silva fight also turning out the way it did, because those are guys that from Abu Dhabi who just gotten in.
Yep.
10%,
yeah.
And he's like, you know,
you spend your money well.
The main
guys.
Event, and yeah, these guys have to watch a fight the main event that Dana absolutely wasn't happy with. So he was extra pissed off about that.
Yeah. Yep.
Well, we got a lot of people that want to say hi to BJ Penn. He's got a new book, Why I Fight. The belt is just an accessory. Let's say hi to Tom. Tom, what's up?
Hello.
Yes. Hey, you're talking to BJ Penn.
It is, Tom.
Hey, guys. I just want to say I love the show.
Thank you, of course.
BJ, I'm a big fan of yours. And I just want to know, do you have any plans on fighting GSP again?
You know, that was in my head, definitely. That's another goal that I want to accomplish. But now that, you know, this happened with Frankie Edgar, first things first, I gotta go get back on top in the lightweight division, and then we'll talk story.
Yeah, I understand. I think you could beat GSP, but and just one last question. I don't mean any disrespect when I ask you this, but when you fought Jens Pulver the second time, why did you hold the choke for a few more seconds? Were you pissed at him or something?
Yeah, maybe a little mad for what happened over the years, I guess. But it's a little bit of show too. What's going on?
What happened over the years?
Well, me and Jens Pulver, just a lot of trash talk. You know, he was the first one to put me in my place. He kicked my butt one night, and ever since then, it was him saying, I can beat him every time I see him. Oh, he ain't nothing. I'll always beat him. He can never beat me, and sometimes that stuff just grows on you.
You know, radio guys trash talk a lot.
Yeah.
But then we don't have to fucking...
You don't have to choke the guy out.
Well, we don't have to choke the guy out.
We just avoid eye contact in the hallway like a bunch of fucking girls.
Yeah, we speak a good game on the mics, but
is that true? Then you give a nod in the elevator.
It's all fun and games.
Wimps.
If it was MMA fighters, they'd be choking each other out in the elevators before they came to work.
God damn.
Hey, Anthony?
Yes, Tom?
Just one more thing before I hang up. Yes. Can you please do your Jesse Ventura impersonation for me, I would really appreciate that.
What am I, a performing seal? Shut
dude,
up, Tom.
Exactly.
Don't make me choke you out for a little longer than necessary.
Exactly. That doesn't make us look good in front of the fighter.
Yes.
Hey, fucking hey, chimp, do that voice you do. Okie dokie.
Really?
Tom, he'll work it in. He'll work
yeah,
it in.
Don't worry. Later
keep
on.
Listening.
Yeah,
all
keep
right,
listening. Good tease.
I was amazed to read this, too. Like, there's a good, I just put gum out. There's a good part where you fought, St. Pierre twice and he's beaten you twice.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, he's looked at kind of like the fans love him and he's seen his royalty in UFC, but, there were allegations that he had, that was the second one where you had commissioned to have his license to fight taken away because you felt that he was, Vaselined up a little bit.
Hmm.
And didn't you hear like one fighter who lost to him say, I couldn't grab his legs. He was
wow.
coated in Vaseline. And you're like, that guy is just complaining you lost.
Mm-hmm.
And then you dealt with it.
Mm-hmm.
And what happened? Do you think that the rules were changed after that? But what do you think was going on with him?
You know, that's what everybody, the conclusion that everybody was coming up to over the years. You know what I mean? That that something like that was going on. And we actually got a call from the guy who was writing the book, Dave Weintraub, he got a call from Kenny Florian, actually. And Kenny Florian was like, tell BJ good luck and to watch out. This guy's a greaser.
By wow, the way, sir.
that's what we call Anthony.
But, yeah, that's something that went on at that time. But honestly, that's not the furthest thing from my mind right now after this.
They changed the rules, though, how much you could put on?
No Vaseline in the locker room. And,
wow.
And only they put the Vaseline
on. The cut man is right, the only one who can have it, and aren't they actually work for the UFC.
Yeah, yeah.
But okay. That was the book, actually. I didn't know that whole backstory, and it's like you get pretty honest in the book, which I like.
And actually, in Japan, there's no Vaseline allowed, period, on your face
anywhere
because of that problem. And they're really, you know, they got different cultures, so they're a lot more strict and different rules.
Mm. Do you want another crack at him?
Yeah, definitely. Mm. But you know, it's hard to sit there and say you want to crack at the welterweight champ when you just lost your lightweight title. You know what I mean? So I got to get back there.
Well, you're the only guy. I think you and Couture are the only guys to have belts in two different.
Weight
classes, right?
Yeah, so that's what would be nice, I guess, from this, you know, become a two-time lightweight champion. That'd be cool.
And then you want to eventually go back and go after him.
Yeah.
Well, there's rumored now that he's going to fight Silva. That was the big thing. That was Silva going to come down or was he going to go?
I think
up?
I don't know what's going to happen, but I think it's a bad idea if Silva goes down. You know, he's the champion at 185. You know, George could try to fight him, but either way, I can't see Silva at 170. That's going to be tough for him, man. And George is very, very strong at 170. You know, I like to see them both at their best, but I know they're at different weight classes, and who knows how it would end up.
Jimmy?
Yes.
Mars wants to ask his question.
Oh, boy.
Mars, you got a question?
Yeah, Mars is a huge MMA fan.
Oh, boy.
I actually didn't have one, BJ, but I thought of one. You got your BJJ purple belt
BJJ?
Under...
BJJ?
Yeah,
Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu.
Okay.
Purple
I didn't know
belt
what it was.
Under
it was stuttering.
The Gracies, correct?
Under Hal Gracie.
And then you received your brown belt and black belt from who?
From Andre Pettinaris.
And why was that? Why did you?
I ended up moving back to Hawaii from California. But so I like about 1 month after I got my purple belt from Hal Gracie, that's the last I trained with him. I trained with Hal for about a year and a half.
Okay. No bad blood there with the Gracies?
I mean, maybe there's some bad blood from Half, and I know that he probably is not too fond of me, but you know what? Looking back, he really helped me a lot. I really don't really have anything bad to say about him. He really tried his best to help me. You know, I ended up moving back to Hawaii. He's all bent out of shape about it, but you know what? He might be pissed off and this and that, and I'm just like, whatever. You helped me a lot. I got nothing bad to say.
Well, you fought, it was...
Thanks for bringing it up, Mark.
Exactly. Exactly. Anything else unpleasant?
We're having a good time talking about it.
Yeah.
And you put a pall over the whole room.
So, I'm in the truck and shit your pants on New Year's Eve.
You could throw Mars for that double glass and we'll videotape it and make it a fucking video sensation. But fuck Mars.
I can't
trying to keep it light and fun.
You can't win, Mars.
But you fought... I never know how to say the Gracie names. Is it Henzo, is that his name?
Yeah. Yeah.
And you and he, I think you beat him in a decision, right?
Uh-huh.
And you said that kind of helped a lot of the bad blood once you guys just, he was fighting for his family's thing and you guys got to get on there and settled it, and it kind of helped things a little bit.
It kind of made things worse, actually.
Oh, did it really? Just jumping right in the fucking dickhead.
Good one, Jim.
I got it completely wrong.
You couldn't have been more wrong.
I couldn't have been wronger if he walked in if I said, congratulations on your victory last week. I really am a fucking idiot. My apologies. Did it make it work probably because you won?
Yeah, probably if I would have got beat up, it might have been better. But, between me and Henzo's a businessman. He's not about that. But it's more, I think, Half's been out of shape. But I'm not the only guy. It's all of his students. Every one of his black belts have left him. And it's one of those things, if you don't want to see anyone ever again, tell him not to leave. You know what I mean? if you say, go ahead, go, come back, show me what you've learned, then he'd still have all his guys. And that's just the nature of the game.
So guys get possessive. I didn't realize guys got possessive in that world, too.
Very, very possessive. Yeah.
Wow, really? Yeah, they don't want
you. In the world of martial arts, not as much in the UFC because, it's a money thing and everybody's right. Professionals in there. It's a honor. It's a different
thing. As far as getting your belts and...
Yeah, you're one of their soldiers is what it is.
So it's almost looked at, I guess, as disloyal to...
As traitor. You're a traitor.
Jeez,
yeah.
Wow. Who knew that was going on?
And all the guys who are in UFC that we talked to a lot of the... Everyone has been nice. It's amazing, with boxing, there's a weird... And again, maybe because, I don't know, they're making $20 million a fight, but the UFC guys are always nice. Yeah. And I do credit a lot Dana with a lot of that because I like the fact that he keeps a lot of this stuff public. Like, it's not all this... lawyer shit. I'm sure that's part of it. But when he was mad at Tito, he said he was mad at Tito. And he's a pretty, he was mad at Silva. And he goes, hey, he's running around like a jackass. But at least Silva knows, hey, he's pissed off at me. There's no fucking...
He sets the tone. And the fighters are following his lead, man. It's good.
I met BJ once. You don't remember. Reed Harris introduced us. Me and Bob Kelly. You know who Bob Kelly is?
Reed Harris from WEC?
Yeah.
Okay.
Bob Kelly's a comedian, and he's a huge...
Use the term loosely.
Exactly, yeah. Bob's just a fucking creep. And he loves you. And this is... And what's the thing you do? Because you're from Hawaii. It's when you put your thumb, I believe... What's it called?
Shaka, yeah.
Yeah, okay, and you do that. And so we met I want to say it was the Lesnar fight. It could be the Forrest Griffin fight. And I just said hello, and Bobby went, hey, man... And he did that at you.
No, he didn't.
Yes, he did. He did. He did the hand.
Shaka, yeah.
The shaka.
And you did not give it back to him. Good. You walked away like you took his dick out. I was so fucking happy.
Should have given him that fist in his face.
Do you really? If you would have just knocked his teeth out, nobody would have faulted you.
Yeah, could do us a favor and knock out our friend Bob Kelly. It would make us all real happy.
Stupid Bobby.
Yeah.
Now what?
Just crush in his skull, please.
I wanted to ask a UFC guy this for a long time because I mean a lot of guys probably think that I wrestle around too, but I really don't. But how do you put somebody in an arm bar? I would like to be put in an arm bar, but not a real one. Oof. Could you put me in one, but not a real one, just to show me how your position is?
No, make it real, Jimmy. No,
meaning I don't want it to
no
break.
No pressure on it, yeah.
No pressure, I mean. BJ. I want to know what that feels
lock
like.
Lock it in, let's see.
A little pressure.
Let me see if I can.
A little pressure.
Oh, he's saying
a little pressure.
He's got his leg across me.
Wow. Oh my God, across his neck.
Holy shit.
All right, he's tapping. Jimmy just tapped.
Wow. Dude, that is fucking horrible.
Holy
Jesus. I thought it was just going to be some fun thing where they kind of hold your arm. What happens is, and you've all seen the arm bar, but his legs, when I saw the sneaker coming up, I was like, yeah, buddy.
There was a sneaker across your waist, or a leg across your waist.
Shit.
The other leg was across pretty much your chest and neck.
Yeah.
And then your arm was between his legs, and then he pulled down on it.
He pulled back.
Had a lot of leverage on you.
But I didn't realize.
And we were sitting in the chair.
Yeah, yes. He's sitting in a chair.
Yeah.
And you tapped out in a chair.
He's lounging. He's got the remote in one hand, and me groveling in the other. But this is what I didn't realize about that. Besides the fact that your arm is ready to be ripped out, it puts pressure on your fucking... it stretches you both ways. I didn't realize it did that.
You were being bent in half.
Horrendously. Yeah. And it's amazing. I thought he would just stop, but he was like, he's waiting for me to tap. And I just gave a little ankle tap, like,
yeah,
sir.
Yeah, Jimmy tapped his ankle. Opie got all that, by the way.
Oh, fuck
video.
Yeah, I got it.
So,
thank you, Jimmy.
I cannot wait till this one goes live.
I literally went,
could you stop doing that?
But that makes, by the way, just feeling what that feels like, that makes watching guys get out of it even more impressive. Like,
imagine that now with him putting real force on that.
But
you
that,
fucking, what are you going to do?
Well, Dan Hardy, in the fight against actually St. Pierre, was literally being bent. What would, how, why didn't he tap?
Oh my God,
tap?
Right, yeah, his shoulder looked like it was going to
the inside of his elbow was almost bent the other way.
Oh, yeah, that one time that happened.
Oof.
You know, some people, got flexible arms and flexible joints that week. That's why sometimes you got to choke them.
Oh.
And then again, you know, I think Dan was like, F you, I'm not going to tap. You're not going to finish me tonight.
Oh, wow.
I think that's
he'd
what,
risk just his arm what, pulling
and
out
he
of the
even got
socket
stuck where
then.
His shoulder was in a bad spot, too. And I think it was a very, Dan is strong mentally. And he was like,
I thought it was gonna
I'm
be
not going to let this
wing.
Happen.
That was an amazing fight.
Dude, when you feel there. That, I can't we believe there. That fucking, yeah. it wasn't like, I knew he wasn't going to hurt me for real, but it's like, well, you could feel like, oh, I see where this is going.
Yeah, you know what you mean? My camera wasn't on. Could BJ do that again?
No, how about you get fucking Danny or somebody else to try it on me?
Oh, man, my camera wasn't working. Please.
What was the,
please.
What is the,
we got to get him out of here, by the way.
Yeah.
Oh, you got to go?
He's real late.
He's got other stuff to do.
I mean, we could talk to you for another half hour, BJ.
Yeah. Yeah.
Are you doing more stuff at Sirius XM?
I don't know. I don't know what they got planned.
No? Oh, you're leaving the building.
Okay, we want to be fans and get a couple of pictures.
Yeah,
but BJ Penn, I've been looking at the
book. We really got to get him out of here.
It's honestly, it's great. All the stuff I mentioned, the feud with Dana and the Gracies, all the stuff is talked about in here, which I like that you kept it honest. It wasn't just for inspiration. It was fucking honest about what happened. It's called BJ Penn, Why I Fight. The belt is just an accessory. And it's great, man. When I read of it, I really loved.
Thank you.
Thanks
thank
for coming
you
in, man.
Much.
Yeah, right on, BJ Penn.
I want to thank the Opie and Anthony show. Thank all
thanks,
you guys,
man.
BJPenn.com, too.
Oh,
because he's
you.
Uploading videos of his appearance, the fans are saying. So that's pretty cool. All right, we'll continue in just a bit. Any Tom Petty fans? Any
like
Tom Petty
song,
fans?
Man.
Me and Del was singing Little Runaway.
Great tune, right? I heard this in the Super Bowl a couple years ago. I've never heard
it. I'm
a big Tom Petty fan. 21 years
I
ago.
I liked him in Kevin Costner movie, The Postman.
Was he in The Postman?
Yeah.
That's what ruined that movie.
Terrible.
Tom Petty released his first solo album 21 years ago today.
It was Waterworld on Dirt, by the way.
You guys hear his fucking show on Sirius XM?
No!
Is it on XM? Is it on Sirius? Is it on both? I don't know. Where does he do it from?
One company. What happened?
Tom Petty does a pretty good fucking radio show playing, you know, stuff he likes and stuff.
Oh, look at somebody saying here. It's Blake Snake saying, yeah. In 1979, Opie.
What?
You like fucking...
Tom Petty.
Tom Petty.
Tom Petty is still fucking doing it.
But he got you so bad.
Did he? Did he? Did he?
He got you. Oh, did he nail you?
Oh.
Fucking rookie.
Oh. So BJ Penn leaves the studio. Great interview, by the way. Loved it. Make sure you get his new book. Really cool guy. I think he's going to become a friend of the show. He was
very
so
cool.
Down
very
on
nice
example.
Dude.
And what did he tell you, E-Rock?
Oh my
so,
god!
So if you were listening, and the video hopefully will be up on my YouTube channel, Opie Radio, in about a half hour or so.
Well, shit got hairy in here.
Yeah, Jimmy
it got ugly.
Jimmy decided to take an armbar from BJ Penn.
Yeah, it got a little tense. A couple of men decided to settle a score.
And I love how you go, I want to be in an armbar, but not really. Or how did you phrase it?
Meaning,
and
I wasn't
and
trying
And I'm like,
to...
yeah, right. Like, BJ Penn's not going to try to, you know, make it hurt a little bit because he's got a reputation.
Meaning, like, I wanted to see what the motion of the arm. It's like when you do something like that with a guy like that. I want it to be clear that I'm not being a dick and going, come on, let me see what you got. Like,
Because
guys are assholes, macho.
So basically you were showing respect.
Yeah, because I want to see what it feels like, but not like, hey, let's see what you got.
Right.
I just want, I wanted to see what it felt like.
Okay.
And he showed me. Because I'm sitting there when his sneakers came up and he and what did he say, E-Rock? Apparently I didn't get the full arm bar.
Walking him down to another studio, and he's describing doing the arm bar on Jimmy, and I guess it's his brother he's talking to, and he goes, yeah, and he's like, I was trying to find his chin. I couldn't find his chin. I couldn't get it under his chin.
he wanted to block his foot in under your chin,
but
he couldn't find Jimmy's chin.
The fact that you don't have a chin actually saved your life.
Yes.
So you shouldn't bitch about being chinless anymore.
I would be a great MMA fighter, because every time they would do it, I would just kind of, like, morph and just kind of slither out like a fucking ghost.
Oh, that's great. You couldn't find your chin.
That
that's
was fun.
Great.
Now it's the next one I got to get put in. We got to get, like, the next fighter we have in here. I want to try one of the fucking, what did Lesnar lose? The ankle,
like an MMA
Achilles
cuffled.
Fucking.
What
do
you mean you want to just try something?
I want to see what those things feel like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Pick up your ass.
Not that.
Pretty much where they could go.
I would tap.
Absolutely. You tap?
Yeah.
Tap at the tip?
Yeah.
Tap at the base of his cock. Okay.
That's see, I wouldn't mind enough. Losing a fight like that because you just tap the guy and go, I've had enough.
Yeah.
I would hate to get knocked out the way fucking.
Big fist just plowing into your face.
Frank Mir can't stop getting beaten up.
Oh.
He loves it.
Loves getting punched about the head and face, chest and neck area.
Oh, it's like he's doing penance for past sins.
Yes, Mars, you have something to add?
No.
No.
Nah. Mike's on?
Yeah. Hey, Jimmy, I wouldn't take a heel hook because it's very little play, and once they put it on, it could do damage.
Well, I'll take one, but I'm going to tell them just to show me the position.
Right,
I don't
right.
want them to actually
no
hook
pressure.
It.
How about a choke?
No, choke doesn't hurt. Scary, man.
No, but you just go to sleep.
Fuck that. You just go to sleep. That's what happens when you die.
No, I won't do that, but I will let them show me. Again, it's almost like show me the position. What it, like, okay, I can't move, and that's it.
Yeah.
It's, I'm not going to try to get out of it. But right. A heel hook, that's what is that what tap Mir, what Mir tapped left with?
I think so. That or an ankle lock. I'm not sure. I don't recall. But a heel hook's dangerous.
But it's amazing, though, when a guy has you like that, it's like you really are.
You're just stuck.
You're fucking stuck. You know what you are? You're an elk with a fat ass in the mud while lions fucking attack you.
Exactly. You were.
You're the elk with the fucking juicy ass that the other elks would make fun of. While lions are jumping
funny,
on your back.
Half stuck in the mud as they're eating you. Yes. Well, that sucked.
That was fucking cool, though.
That was very cool. The video is going up, and you're going to love it, people, because I saw it live, and Jimmy's face is priceless.
Dude, to get put in a fucking, a position by a fucking a two-time champion.
That's fucked up.
Yeah.
Very cool, very cool.
I got something to do when I get home to my girlfriend. Fucking armbar that bitch.
It'll be up in
her poor little arm would just snap off.
You stop moving. Oh, and the problem with Edgar, his tongue doesn't bend.
What?
So that's why his tongue comes out. He's like,
ew, it's like hard and pointy like a bird's tongue.
I can't lick my teeth.
So fucking gross, dude.
You're disgusting.
Dude, she'll actually call him by name. She'll be like, just fucking go away, Edgar.
How do you keep that girl?
I don't know.
What's wrong with you?
It makes me happy to be Edgar.
She's fucking beautiful. You're going to lose her, man.
I lose them all. Jesus Christ.
God damn, Jimmy.
That's funny, bro. It should be up in 13 minutes here.
13 minutes?
On Opie Radio YouTube channel. What?
Yeah. It's that it takes so long.
It's stupid.
Fucking pricks. Fucking pricks. I want to bring something up.
Oh, no.
Of course, it's about our great president, Barack Hussein Obama.
I'm surprised you feel that way.
Yeah.
You know what, Ant?
Yeah.
I know what you're going to say, and I agree with you.
Yeah.
I really do on this one.
There is.
I really fucking do.
A pride in this nation that we have been able to hold on to for many, many years. And it is called the space program, NASA. We have been kicking ass in space for years with what we have done. The technology we have been able to come up with as a country out of want or need to do stuff in space. We figure it out. We build it and we did it. And it still shows today with the International Space Station that, by the way, is international in that we paid for over 90% of it.
Wow.
As the United States. That we've ferried up most of the equipment on previous shuttle flights, because that's all the shuttle has done the past few years is just, ferry up equipment and attach it to this big space station that can be used by any country that wishes to go up there and do their experiments. And we went to the moon. We've just done amazing, miraculous things with the space program that has not only gotten us into space and done these amazing things, but has given us technology that we use every goddamn day in computers, in just household equipment, televisions, your kitchen, your cars. There isn't one thing you use on a daily basis that hasn't in some way, shape, or form come out of the space program in this day and age. It's amazing. Different alloys that were needed out of necessity to lighten things. We use them on cars now. It's just astounding. Now, under the wonderful Barack Hussein Obama, NASA's funding has been cut. And the shuttle program is finished. There are three more shuttle flights after this one. And then the shuttles are all going to be retired. They are an aging fleet.
How long will those three shuttles bring us to, like a year from now?
Yeah, probably about...
Like every 4 to 6 months?
Year. Probably about a year.
Maybe
it's
a little over?
Within 2010.
So I'm saying a little over a year, no more space shuttle missions, no more...
By 2011, it's done.
So then our astronauts, what, have to go to Russia to hitch a ride?
Yeah, this is what's happening
now. To go to the space station?
In order to go to the space station that we paid for, pretty much.
That's ridiculous.
We have to now pay... The Soviet Union,
it's fucking ridiculous.
Russia now, but, you know, we have to pay the Russians to ferry us up into the space station because we don't have a spacecraft to take Americans into space anymore because the programs have been cut. It's embarrassing as a nation that was so proud of the Apollo program, Apollo 13, the ingenuity that was used to bring those astronauts back from Apollo 13 and just the shuttle programs obviously the disasters happened, but what they've done over the years with the shuttle is amazing. For how many flights they had and to have two disasters like that, it's really an amazing safety record, quite frankly.
Pretty impressive.
86 and then a couple of years ago, right?
Yeah, it's just...
When we're off the air.
I am embarrassed.
That's like 6 years ago.
I'm already, embarrassed for our country and our stupid fucking president that the funding has been cut to the point where we don't have a spacecraft that can take our astronauts up to the space station.
Can I ask you something? I thought there was supposed to be a new fleet of shuttles.
No.
I remember reading about that about a year ago.
They were... funding a new spacecraft, a regular type of rocket, you know, your standard capsule rocket ship, not a glider that comes back. The shuttle program is done. They've talked about it, getting a shuttle, another shuttle program, but the money, too much, and they will not fund the program.
Can I ask you a question? Does it have anything to do with the fact Richard Branson... and all of these private industries are now making them or going to be making them, and maybe in the next 5 to 7 years, there's going to be a lot of, I mean, I'm asking, a lot of alternate ways to get up. Like, again, I know they can't do what the shuttle can do.
Yeah.
But is it going to become something that's going to become obsolete as private industry makes more and more of these spacecraft?
Yeah, I think in years, many years to come, you're going to see a lot more private enterprises coming up with spacecraft to take people into space. Right now isn't the time to cut the programming, though. It's we're not at that point yet.
There's a giant gap
in between NASA and the government-funded space program and private enterprise ferrying astronauts and whatever up to the space station.
But how cool is it that we have a space station up there right now?
Yeah, great. And we got to go to the Russians to go up to it. Now, what happens if we have a falling out with the Ruskies? That happens every few years, and they tell us to go fuck ourselves. Now we can't even use the space station, which represents the high ground, quite frankly. They're now in charge of something we paid 90% of, so that the French and fucking Russians and Germans and whoever else want to go up there can go up there, but we can't.
Haven't we always cooperated space-wise, though?
No. Yeah, like, we've been pretty good. Even Apollo-Soyuz during the Soviet years, we were there. But this is an embarrassment for the country.
But the space station is the coolest tree fort ever.
It really is. Isn't it the bestest tree fort? It's a tree fort, but the big brother pulled the ladder up on us.
But that's all it is. It's a tree fort. It's the coolest tree fort. They're not really doing anything. They're just hanging out going, look what we could do.
It's where the lords hang out.
That's right.
The lords.
Hey, we got a guy from a little I was going to call it a company, a little company called NASA. What the hell?
Yeah.
Mike in Houston. What's up, Mikey?
Hey, what's going on? Hey, Ant.
Yeah.
Normally, you are dead on about everything. Here, you're not entirely right.
All right.
Isn't Obama cutting the funding? If you guys got like 30 seconds, I can give you a little bit of background.
We'll give you 22.
Okay, good. After Columbia, George Bush created the vision for space exploration, said we're going to the moon, to Mars, and beyond. And he created a budget for what's called the Constellation Program.
Right.
So the president, he gives his budget, and then Congress passes an authorization bill saying this is how much NASA is allowed to spend.
Mm-hmm.
Then they have to pass what's called an appropriations bill.
Right.
That's where they actually say this is how much money we're going to give you. You know, there was money authorized. Congress said you will have this many billion dollars to build these big moon rocks.
I know that. That was under Bush.
Congress never appropriated that money. Constellation was never funded. That's why it was so far behind. So now we've spent $8 billion, and we have nothing. We have what's essentially one big model rocket, the Ares 1X, that thing that went off about a year ago now.
Yeah.
We've had nothing else.
So,
and Obama didn't cancel this. It was underfunded under George Bush.
So now what
Obama's doing is essentially rearranging the funds so that we actually might be able to do something in the future.
Obama canceled that program that was supposed to take us to the moon as a launching pad for Mars mission.
But the program of record was unsustainable. They had the Augustine Commission. I mean, he appointed a blue panel commission, the same guy who ran the Challenger accident. This guy.
How is it?
If Constellation was given to us today,
yeah.
The first thing that we would do is cancel it because it will be too expensive.
How is it then we were able to go to the fucking moon in 1969, and we can't fund it now?
They put about 1.5% of the national budget. Went towards NASA for those 10 years.
So do it again. Do you know how many jobs that makes?
0.3%.
But do you know how many jobs that makes and how much technology comes out? I know, that's what I'm saying. And how much technology comes out of it? You know. It's amazing. Is it not worth it?
You're a Republican. You're saying that NASA should be a jobs program?
No, I'm saying it's a program that over the years has given this nation pride and a product.
I'm there with you, but you have to spend the money the right way and you have to have the right goal. I don't like the fact that his fiscal year 2011 budget came out and there was no plan and there were no details. That sucked his dick.
So what plan is there in place?
Obama didn't cancel shuttle, by the way. That was
I know Obama didn't cancel the shuttle. I wasn't saying Obama canceled the shuttle.
For NASA by $6 billion over 5 years.
Right. I wasn't saying Obama canceled the shuttle. Believe me. I'm not saying that.
Kinda did.
No, I didn't.
You kind of did.
I said that there is nothing in place. And it is so low priority to put to have a craft that will put our men in space, our people, whatever the fuck.
That we have the space shuttle that it's hitting its stride.
Right.
We've had a bunch of great missions in a row, and now that they're saying that we're going to cancel it, I think that is moronic.
Exactly.
But you have to realize it takes an army of workers to get that orbiter flying every time. It is not. It was supposed to. You know, it was an experimental vehicle. It was never supposed to become operational. We can't treat it like an operational vehicle.
Well, this
it takes a crap load of work every time.
What is the next step then? What is the plan for getting Americans back in space on American built and launched spacecraft?
We have no idea.
Exactly. That's what I'm talking about.
On the 15th, Obama was supposed to be having a space summit.
Oh, he's too busy giving our nuclear arms away.
He's going to be there for 45 minutes. We don't know. That's the frustrating thing is nobody knows.
Well, that's what upsets me. This is a president who isn't making this a priority. And to tell you the truth, I think it's a big priority. Like I said, it creates jobs. It creates technology, which creates more jobs. I'm just saying it's so much has come out of the space program and we are throwing it away and relinquishing our, superiority to a lot of other countries, including again, fucking China, who, you know, have rockets that say place on ground, light fuse, get away.
And we got they got better rockets than we do now. At least they could put people in space.
No, they certainly do not. No. They do not have better rockets than we do. That is not even close. What they have is a rocket that is based on the Russian Soyuz technology. So they pretty much bought all of the Russian designs and then added their own couple of little tweaks to it. What the Russians and Chinese have is not even close to what we have.
A big Vostok rocket.
The guys from Lockheed and the guys from Boeing build most of the rockets that launch stuff now. Yeah. It's not even close.
All right. Thank you, Mike. Mike in Houston, who works for NASA.
I have a question.
For Mike?
Yeah, Mike.
All right. He's gone. I didn't do that. I'm sorry.
That's all right. They were going to try some program because there was this new hotshot astronaut. Who's supposed to be really good.
Oh, really? Jimmy?
Yeah.
What's his name?
Lorenzo Fuzzbutter.
No, it's not.
It is.
Fuzzbutter.
Fuzzbutter.
Lorenzo Fuzzbutter.
Yeah.
And he's a hot shot astronaut.
He's a hot shot astronaut.
Kind of a loose cannon.
He does loop-de-loos.
that's what makes him a hot astronaut?
Loop-de-loos?
Yeah. What are they called?
Whatever. Pretty much
I don't care what thing he calls them.
Yeah, he has Rocket Man tattooed on his bicep.
Anthony, question for you.
Yes.
You bitch and complain when Obama spends so much goddamn money, and now this is saving the United States of America a lot of money. What's your feelings on that?
Do you think I bitch and complain when he spends money? No. Yeah.
Well, the healthcare
I bitch and complain
thing.
When he spends money on shit I don't think is productive for this country. That's what I complain about.
So space program, very productive for this
very
country.
Productive
healthcare,
for this
not
country.
So much.
Very productive
and
for
healthcare,
this
not so much.
Do you know
Obamacare?
Do you know
not
what
so much.
Medicines and stuff have come out of the space program? Everything.
Tang
and
yes, eye drops.
Beautiful Tang and
little known fact, eye drops.
I'm just saying it's computers.
I don't know.
The advancement of computers because of the space program and the military war.
Yeah.
Is astounding. So I don't.
Is Neil Armstrong on your side?
Yes, Neil Armstrong is definitely on our side.
He's very pissed off.
It's embarrassing the United States of America to not have a ship that could take fucking American astronauts.
But is that what Neil Armstrong is saying?
Yes.
So I'd rather listen to what he has to say about the space program.
Yes, one small step for man.
Yeah. He said for a man.
A man.
He's kind of a recluse. He doesn't come out unless it's some major event with Michael Collins, Buzz Aldrin, and him.
I'm sure Aldrin wants to punch somebody.
Hey, speaking of famous space quotes, you were telling me before the show about Houston, we got a problem.
Yes, you know something? It was, I believe, 40 years ago yesterday that Apollo 13 had their big malfunction that you might remember from the movie Apollo 13.
Starring Tom Hanks.
Starring Tom Hanks as Jim Lovell. And do you know, he actually said, Houston, we've had a problem. Not Houston, we have a problem.
Really?
Yes, they changed it for the movie to make it sound a little more urgent. Like, we have a problem instead of we've had a problem. Sounds like, all right, we had this problem. But we have a problem is... But the actual line was, we've had a problem.
The reason they changed it, and Hank said this in an interview, is because he believes that apostrophes are for queers. And he won't say we've ever.
All right, listen, we...
goddamn.
We,
No NASA, no I Dream of Jeannie. Thank you. See, we wouldn't have had I Dream of Jeannie.
privatize. Are we really going to discuss space for a while?
No, I just wanted to say, I don't give a shit.
Missions are gone.
You think I care what the listeners fucking think about this?
I care. They care.
You think
we
I give a shit?
Care.
I am complaining because it's embarrassing.
Right. Listen.
As a proud American who watched the first men step out onto the moon as a little lad, I am embarrassed.
Little lad, you were in high school.
Right. I was running the ship. I was at Houston Control.
You were fucking standing there with an afro. Fucking bell bottoms.
You drove your boys to the local movie theater to check it out. Who are you kidding?
Listening to rock music and bad mouthing your country, I'll bet.
No, I watched a little TV in Flushing.
Now, we got lots going on. We got your date from last night outside the studio.
Yes!
But we want to break before we do that. But before we even break, we want to do something else because there's so much going on today. Remember yesterday, the energy drink video?
Yeah.
We got the guy supposedly on the line to explain it.
Yeah.
And then we'll get Taylor in here. Taylor Vixen.
Yes. Do we have to break? How long have we been going?
Oh, we don't have to break.
Yeah, why don't we not break?
I'm not saying we're breaking like right this second. But now we're not breaking because we found out that Taylor only has
Taylor's
got
to leave at
let
nine.
Let me grab this phone call real fast.
Just busy
because
girl.
Yesterday, Danny brought it to our attention, this mm-hmm. video where this guy who's trying to get an energy drink going.
Yeah.
Put, what, hundreds and hundreds of cases of the energy drink in his house. And his mom freaked out. Like, do you remember that from yesterday, everybody? I hope you do. Danny remembers. And we were questioning the video. Well, we got Mike. Mike from New York.
Mike!
Was that your video, Mike?
Yeah, it was.
How do we know?
You can check my number. It's on our website. Phone number.
Right. So you're trying to get an energy drink thing happening, right? You got a new energy drink. We're thinking that the fucking video was set up.
What?
Was the video real or was it not real?
Oh, 100% real.
Yeah?
Actually, I thought my dad was going to freak out. My mom, I've never seen her freak out like that.
She lost her fucking mind, dude.
Just because you had cases of the energy drink all over the house.
Yeah, she's a psychologist. And she said she always tells us my dad is like semi-autistic. And so we thought he was going to flip out about his hats being on the ground. But
his hats being on the ground?
Totally lost her marbles.
Look at his hats. Looks like a bunch of people just stepped out of an elevator in the Bronx.
Wow. Your mom handled it really well. My mom didn't freak out like that when she caught me blowing somebody when I was six.
It's my dad.
It's been hard to keep it up. She's asking me to take it down.
Really?
Yeah. Wow. Actually, she 3 weeks ago, she told me I could put it up, and then I put it up, and she found out at work from a coworker. She didn't talk to me for 2 days.
Yeah, but I'm confused, man. You're starting a new company, obviously. You got this video of your mom freaking out. It's getting some attention. It got our attention, certainly, and more people are checking out the video. Why would she want it taken down if this is good for you and good for your business?
That's what I'm trying to explain to her, but it's, as you can see from the video, it's a little hard to deal with her if she's freaking out.
Yeah, apparently it's very hard to be rational. She's screaming like she's calling 911 and she's looking at a murder scene.
Yeah, and they... when she was first dialing, she actually dialed me, and she left me a voicemail, and then the phone starts beeping. So a lot of people are commenting, oh, the phone's beeping, it's fake or something, but it's another phone.
So you're here to say that this video is not fake.
Yeah.
It's what?
It's real.
Yeah, 100% real.
All right.
I'm speaking French today. Jesus.
Well, there you go.
Good luck with the drink. God bless.
Yeah, what's
thanks, man. Appreciate it.
What's the name of the drink? What the hell? We'll help you out a little bit.
Vital Energy, and the video was Epic Nervous Breakdown Caused by Vital Energy.
All right, very good. All right, you're saying it's real. Are you a fan of the show, or did someone tell you that we were talking about it?
Oh, no. Someone told me, actually, my coworker or business partner listens to you guys. I used to listen to you a year ago when I was in Michigan, but I had to cancel my
accent. Fascinating.
Yeah.
All right.
Godspeed.
All right, you guys really could give a shit about
I could give a shit about why am I giving a shit about him when we have a beautiful girl out here?
All right. This
guy's, my God.
Enjoy your drink. Run fast after having some. Hot chick in.
Good.
Hot chick in.
Come here, sweetie.
I'm right here. Sugary beverage out. Hot chick in.
All right, Mike. Your timing is just bad, unfortunately, because we do have Taylor Vixen.
You can sit right here.
The penthouse pet of the year.
Aww.
Hi,
hello,
Taylor.
How are you?
Look at you. Shut up, Jimmy.
My
name's Jimmy.
Jim.
Oh, wait, you guys never met.
We have not.
Don't give her a chair, you cock blocker.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, it's a good movie, Rock.
Go. Oh, there we go. Wait. Oh, there we go.
This.
That's much better. How have you been?
Me, I'm good.
How's your night?
I'm really tired.
Yeah, huh?
I am.
Yeah.
I am.
Taylor, can I ask you, because
I want to hear.
Okay.
Oh, she needs headphones. Yeah. Fuck. Stupid place is set up like shit.
I know. How is a man supposed to have a girl on his lap?
I know.
So you went out with, you picked a great restaurant, by the way.
Yeah.
Now, when you got there and you saw Anthony, and what kind of a date is Anthony? Because I think he's much nicer than people think he is.
Well, first of all, I had a million texts this morning overhearing whatever y'all were talking about.
I know, we were just discussing the date. We were, very respectful. We certainly were.
People like drawing their own conclusions.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
They like to exaggerate out there.
They certainly do.
Twitter was interesting.
Why did you pick the Brazilian meat house for a date with Anthony?
Well, I'm from Texas, and we love meat there.
Yeah.
And I love Fogo de Chão.
Mm-hmm.
But
what is that?
It is a Brazilian steakhouse. Oh. There's actually not one here in the city. We figured that out. And I think that place is better still.
It's great.
Yeah.
You know, have you been there?
Many times. It's got one of the, when Anthony told me where he was going, It's one of the cleanest ratings in New York. It's like as far as being a hygienic place to eat, it's phenomenal. And they have them in Rio. I was in Rio.
Which one?
The one you guys went to.
Oh, I'm talking about
it. No, she's saying the other one's still better.
Oh, okay. I've not been to that one, but Platform I've been to.
I have to say it was really good. No, it was really good.
Yeah, they just keep bringing the meat.
Yeah. And the desserts are delicious. They have them in Brazil.
We didn't have any dessert.
No?
We filled up so much on stupid meat.
Lots of meat.
How much meat did you have, Taylor?
I don't know. Enough.
You were saying no thanks a lot, too.
We were all saying no thanks, but... Yeah. Anthony sure likes his meat.
Yeah.
He was like, yes, please.
Yes, please.
Meat, please.
Meat.
was he being sweet, Anthony? Because I like when he's sweet, Anthony.
You like sweet Anthony.
I like sweet Anthony.
Sweet. We had so much fun. I think we laughed the whole time.
I know. We really did have a good time.
Lots of stories.
Yeah. See, we were telling a lot of nice, fun stories. Just laughing.
Like crazy the gun story.
Of course. I loved the gun stories and
who had the
stories about people of other racial and ethnic backgrounds.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, a couple of those.
I'm sure Anthony recommended a website for you. You might want to.
He didn't.
No, see, I didn't think of any of that. No websites. It's only one great website to go to, and that's Taylor's.
Yeah, it's mine. Taylor Vixen.
So was Anthony nicer than you thought he'd be? Tell the truth, because he's a radio shock jock,
yes,
quote unquote.
And okay, he had more of a personality than I thought. But I bet you thought the same about me.
Yes, I totally did. You know, you get your preconceived notions that it's going to be a girl from Penthouse, and she's just going to be, you know. And I knew when you were in here the other day that you had a little more going on than just that. But then you go out and hang out and talk, and you realize, yeah, girls, you know. Cool.
She's got She's got a little.
She's like a real girl. You know, it's not just.
But it was
very,
a lot of fun.
Extremely hot girl. It was.
You had your friend come. Was that just in case he was a creep? Let's be honest.
Well,
he's a nice guy, but you never know, right?
But it's but it's like you really don't know anybody. And honestly, I'm like more the merrier. In general, like going out. I love people.
Good thing.
I like that.
And it just brings more conversation. It brings more getting to know other people. She lives in Jersey. She's from Dallas. Cute girl. Why not bring it?
Yeah.
I'm pimping her out too.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
She was pimping her out.
And it's nice that Selfish didn't think to bring one of his friends.
Hey, he's only working on himself.
I don't have friends.
I would have been happy just to leave you two alone, and I would have just talked to your attractive friend.
See, that would have been nice, see?
And she would have probably been like, why? I'm just kidding.
What are you doing?
No, she probably would have been like that, but I'm a very good conversationalist.
She's a really cool chick.
Now, you're going to be going back to Los Angeles.
Yes, I leave tomorrow. I miss home so much. I've been here since last Wednesday.
Yeah. Like L.A.?
I do. The weather, much better. Not as crowded.
Yeah.
This place is so crowded.
I noticed something. You guys are back to small talk. What happened?
What? Well, we're in a room with you fucking idiots.
They're back to small talking.
Well, what are you going to say?
They're talking about the weather.
No.
We want to know what happened last night.
Carly just texted me and said, thank you, Anthony. You're such a sweetie for last night.
Oh, see? I was being
Carly,
sweetie.
Her name is? That's a
yes,
kind of
her
a
name's
name.
Carly.
You had to pick up her meat bill.
Everyone's meat bill.
Where does Carly live in New Jersey?
Yes.
What parts? I grew up in New Jersey.
Am I saying this right? Brunswick or something?
Brunswick? I grew up in North Brunswick.
She's been living there for about 5 years.
It's north of Brunswick.
No. There's North Brunswick, East Brunswick, South Brunswick, and New Brunswick.
Shut up.
New Brunswick is where all the...
live.
Jesus.
Hey, you ass. Now, when you're in L.A., let's say I had reason to go to Los Angeles.
There was a trial, something to do with Phil Spector, file trading with Gary Glitter.
I would take you to Fogo de Chao.
Would you?
Yes.
All right.
You know,
that'd be cool.
This room feels so much cleaner. It's different.
Yeah.
Trace isn't here.
Oh, damn. Oh, no, you didn't. Patrice was here and just did nothing but give her a hard time. Trying to pull his Patrice not interested charm on her. And it was failing miserably.
It didn't work, huh?
No. You know that Patrice, like, I don't give a shit.
Yeah.
Fuck that bitch. You got this and blah. I don't like that. That's Patrice.
Yeah.
And
he
thinks the girls are just
really
going to, like, claw onto him. And that's, like, his technique.
Are you
and
saying,
it didn't work.
Are you saying his reverse psychology didn't work?
Exactly.
that might work with his bitches.
But I love to see all the flaws he has to point out about me. That was fun.
He's blind.
Yeah, we were
great. I loved it.
Tell him to go fuck himself.
Everyone's got flaws. I mean, you know, hot chicks have them.
Oh, we all have them.
Believe it or not, I have a few physical flaws, too. They're not apparent to the eye, though.
Yeah, I can't really see any flaws. You look perfect.
Jimmy is just a sweet,
Taylor,
sweet boy.
Are you hungover today? You got the big Hollywood glasses on.
Because my eyes are like a little red. I'm just really tired.
Can we see?
Yeah, can we see
your eyes red?
Can we see your beautiful eyes?
Those are good martinis.
Oh, look.
Is that? Yeah.
No, not at all.
Okay.
You do look. She looks very, very girl next door. Very.
I know.
Very like.
That's why I love that look. It's really nice.
I am very
really
girl
nice.
Next door.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
How did you? I'm sure these guys covered this, but how did you come to pose in Penthouse? Had you done other stuff before, or is it like?
I did like two other things before, but I just kind of sent my pictures in. I got bored one day. So I know it sounds weird.
Was a boyfriend or whatever at the time take a picture of you? Because I've had girls that would let me and girls that would not let me take photos of them. We date someone who's like,
obviously I had to send something in, right?
Mm-hmm.
So at the time I had someone take pictures for me, like just raw shots, you know, to send in. And yeah, that person was like, you look great. You should do it. Just someone I was dating.
Oh, okay. He's old hat now. He's gone.
Yeah, we're friends.
Uh-oh.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, I'm friends. I'm great with that. I'm friends with everyone.
Yeah, what are you going to do?
I want to know more about last night.
What do you want to know?
Last night.
Just because we got your side of the story.
You're a busybody.
You brought it to everyone's attention out there, so I got to do my job. I mean, we got Anthony's side of the date.
And he was talked about
he
how
he really liked it.
It was a
lot of fun.
A lot of drinking,
a lot of meat eating, a lot of laughing. What else you said? A lot of racism.
Laughing. Basically, at one point at the end of the night, we were just laughing at all what the people on Twitter were saying.
Yeah, there was a lot
about,
of tweeting.
About, hey, your daughter looks great.
That's a good one. We want to get into.
And then one of them said, Taylor, Anthony has AIDS.
That's a cock blocking asshole. That's not what I meant.
Don't get in the back of the van with him. I mean, it was
help me out with this couch, would you?
Well, I was telling him that before I got there, I go, my Twitter completely went the opposite way. Like, every tweet is about Anthony. I'm like, these guys love Anthony.
Yes.
Because they are like, and this.
They live vicariously through me. So, you know,
you and
to
your
go
big
out
hog.
With the penthouse.
We have some great pictures that I didn't have my reader to upload last night.
Yeah.
But we have some great pictures that I'm going to send.
Yeah, send me the pictures and I'll pop them up because I think some faces have to be digitized out.
Yes, we got arrested.
Yeah, it was close.
What? Yeah.
There was some police involved, so.
You'll see the pictures.
Leave it at that.
Oh, okay.
We'll just leave it at that.
So their faces
but,
have to be.
But yeah, Anthony got us out of it, thank goodness.
Yeah.
Wait, you got arrested?
I'm pretty good with that.
Yeah. I get arrested every day. Come on.
We were.
Well, oh no. Are you a bit of a troublemaker?
When I was younger, yes.
No.
I was really bad. I was always in grounded. My grounded like overlapped each other.
But I mean, when you go out, like when you drink a little bit, are you kind of like a fight starter?
No.
Okay.
I'm a happy
she's
drunk.
Fun.
Oh, she is
happy.
Good. Okay.
Yeah, she gets very happy and
very
fun.
Very happy.
And the police got involved. There was a public.
There
was a little public display going
Carly
on.
Didn't get arrested, so.
No.
Wait, what happened?
Did Carly, let's just say,
what can you say about
did
this?
Did Carly's bosoms fall out?
I can't really talk about it.
We saw some pictures, though.
Yeah.
Wait a minute.
You have them?
Wait, who got arrested?
I can't show them.
We didn't get arrested. We came close.
Wow.
Close.
We were hanging out.
For what reason?
There was some shenanigans going on. Yeah. It was,
You have pictures.
Yeah,
it's kind of like you know the movie. The
wait, was there a little kissing?
No, nothing like that. It was, you know,
happened? Donkey show.
Yeah,
what do you? You
it was, you know,
you got to give us something.
We were doing
give us something.
We were doing show and tell.
Were you showing? Yeah. Were you showing?
We were doing show and tell.
Were you showing old school?
And
Anthony was running down the aisle. What am I saying? Anthony was running down the alley. Flinging his dick out. And I was like, Anthony, stop running down the alleys flinging your dick out.
It was, you know, one of those, you show me yours, I'll show you mine. And the cops showed up and it was kind of a, you know, it happens.
And, Somehow I got involved.
But, you know, I got a couple of connections. And
he does, thank goodness.
Things were settled.
That's
so
great.
feet.
Yeah, what are you going to do?
I love you. Show me yours. I'll show you mine. I love it's so much fun.
Like kindergarten, you know.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. That's why I got fired. Uncle Paul. All right, so I didn't know that part. Anthony,
but all around, no. It was a great night.
Yes. Would you date Anthony again? Would you go out with him for dinner again at one point? He's a nice guy.
Maybe when I come back into town.
Yeah, I'm thinking when you come back.
He wants to get you in a bikini.
Well, who doesn't?
Well, I'm just saying.
Oh, Google it.
See that at the yeah. I'm
just kidding.
No, I would love to see her poolside. It'd be wonderful.
Yeah, that'd be all right.
Yeah.
Anthony's house.
I have to drag you out to the compound, the mansion.
The compound just sounds scary. It sounds like I'm going to the compound in Waco, Texas.
Yeah, I know, but
it's really
not.
You really got to change the name of the place, fun. Aunt. She's right.
It's a fun compound.
It doesn't look like a compound. It's just a
reminds me of that place in Waco. Remember yes. that?
Well, yeah. It probably would. No.
Yes. It's kind of like that with more radical thinking.
You asshole.
It's actually an extraordinary gentleman's house. You would never think that it belongs to a guy who's very naughty on the radio.
He talked about his really decorated.
Yeah.
Talking about that.
Yeah, see? Ange came in and decorated everything because I had nothing. And decorated the house and did a great job. And I think you'd love it. So next time you're in town, maybe we could have dinner and pop by there.
We'll all go for a swim.
And the pool will be heated. I love a nice heated pool.
Mm.
So it's...
Just don't go into the jacuzzi, because that tends to not be heated.
Shut up. It is, too. I know how it works now. Right. Jimmy was making fun of my gazpacho soup jacuzzi.
Yeah, I went in there once, and it was fucking like -8, and the pool was all hot. My little testicle shriveled in the jacuzzi. I was just trying to be a stud.
It didn't work out for
you. Jacuzzis are the best.
Yeah, Anthony's place is, but you can go. This is the thing, Anthony. You can go to Anthony's house without feeling there's going to be pressure for sex because it's like a massive
place. It's sprawling. There are plenty
of
rooms.
Anthony's harmless.
He is.
That's
right.
That's it. See, I'm harmless. Yeah, and fun, right?
Harmless, fun, has connections to get us out of getting arrested.
Yeah,
Jesus.
See, that's
how close. How close were you? Like, let's just say that. How was it? Was it a case of it was going to happen, or were you kind of close?
We were against the car.
It was close, yeah. But Anthony's like, you know,
like,
saying all this stuff.
And I said enough.
I know something.
Got us out of a situation.
And I, you know, popped
you
out of centerfold. I did what I could do.
Yeah.
No, you
showed who
let
she
a
was.
Pop out or something.
Yeah.
To distract the cops.
But who called them?
I think it was just a lapse in judgment and somebody seeing that shouldn't have been there. Wrong place, wrong time.
Okay.
You know.
Sure.
You see that happen all the time.
There's
on
a lot
cops.
Of vagary going on right now.
Like,
a lot of vagary.
Well, vagary's understandable.
That's the best.
I don't even know if that's
like
a word,
keeping,
but I'll
serious.
Use it.
Vagary. Keeping it a little vague so no one gets in trouble.
What
or
part
anything.
Of the city just happened? What part of the city?
It was meatpacking. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Meatpacking district there. So,
You know. Gotta watch it down there, though, because there's a lot of stuff that goes on that's not exactly wholesome. So
I thought meatpacking would be fine. You know.
Yeah.
It's not like you're... Midtown.
He was trying to really meatpack.
Yeah.
Was Ann making the moves on you, Taylor?
Is he smooth?
I told you, he's nice.
Did he attempt a couple moves? Come on.
I'm extremely nice.
You'll never see
no.
me.
No.
Let's get in first.
I will first. See him again.
First date.
No, he was very sweet.
What was his move, though?
I don't know. It was no move.
Yeah.
Did he go in for a kiss?
I don't think he knows. No.
I don't do a move. Did he do the thing where he yawns and puts his arm around you? That's a good one in the movie theater?
No.
He's so nice.
He took nice pictures.
Did he rub his engorged cock on your fucking leg?
Shut up.
It made it look like it was by accident.
Does that turn you on?
Yeah.
About Anthony's cock?
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, damn.
Did he press up against you and go, sorry, I didn't really mean to do that.
Does he do that to you a lot?
Yeah, he does.
First of all of us.
Yeah.
We all pretend we don't like it.
Right.
But we do.
Yeah.
If we didn't like it,
what was his move, though? He had to have a little move. I'm not
saying...
His
move is being nice and smooth. I think that's his move.
Thank you.
See? It really is. If you have someone that's like, I want to fuck you, blah, blah, blah.
Oh, no, we're not saying that it was like that.
Yeah.
But there was something in between, I'm thinking.
His move was making sure we were taken care of, making sure that, you know, the bar closed, right?
Yes.
And they're like, we're not serving drinks out here anymore. And Anthony's like, well, we need drinks. So you went inside and got him and brought him outside?
Yeah, see? So we could still hang out outside for a little while
longer. He made the night go.
Yeah, you know, you never want people wanting for something.
Right.
You know, or standing around or waiting for things. No waiting.
No waiting was involved.
Yeah.
Anthony's a good date, I would think.
Oh, thank you,
great.
Jimmy.
He's my friend.
We basically had like a threesome date.
Yeah, it was wonderful.
We should do a double date.
That's why I brought another hot girl. That was perfect.
Listen, yeah, we should do really a double date. It's about time I got involved with the situation.
Really? You want to get involved in this, Jimmy?
I do.
You want to get involved with this double date thing?
I do. I'm fun on a date. I just point out crime statistics.
who are you going to bring, though, Jimmy?
What's that?
Who are you going to bring on this
double date? I would allow my friends to pick a friend for me.
Oh, well, that's nice.
Sure.
Yes. Unless my girlfriend wanted to come, in which case I would bring her.
That could be an issue.
That could be nice, right? Bringing your girlfriend on the double date.
I would actually. Yeah, I would bring my girlfriend.
Makes sense. Sure,
I would.
Yeah,
yeah, she's nice.
I would probably go for her too.
Yeah, yeah. Taylor likes girls.
Oh, you like?
Yeah,
yeah.
She likes girls.
Yes.
You like girls?
Do you prefer them or do you? You prefer them or no?
You know, since I work with girls a lot, I prefer guys. But I prefer girl. It's just like, you know, it's work more now.
Do you do video at all? Like any of the
video
softer?
Video girls.
Oh, you do soft or hardcore?
Hardcore girls.
Oh, you do? Wow, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
She's wearing a big coat today. Yeah. And
it's not a big coat. It's a nice
it's a big
little
coat.
It actually
trench
feels good in here,
thing.
So I can take my coat off.
Yeah, take your coat off, because Jimmy wasn't here the other day. It was some terrific stuff.
I have
going
seen
on.
Your photos. You're very lovely. I might
yeah.
Holy
see,
mackerel.
Yeah, see that, Jimmy? That's very nice. See?
My God.
Got a nice, nice t-shirt on. And people were yelling and screaming because I put a video up, and they're saying those are not real. They're real.
Stop it. They're totally fucking real.
They're totally real.
Out of your mind.
I'm holding my water bottle. Is this a giveaway? If you take your jacket off, I go.
Came closer. Yes, they're real. And I don't know. A lot of people, like, you know, I shoot to shoots all the time, and the photographer will be like, okay, now bra. And he's like, are your boobs real? Like, and I'm like, yes. Yeah. They shoot girls every day. They do it I get it pretty much every time.
They hurt your back?
Yes. See if I sit up straight.
Wow. Yeah.
I work for unsexyquestions.com. What an asshole I am.
Your back.
Yes.
I really do. What's
I really have a fucking.
She's 26, 27. That's not a question to ask a 26 year old.
I know,
with
but
big
why
boobs.
Would I? Why would I think? You know, that's what I think of it. That's how fucking what an older man I'm becoming.
Yeah.
I see big boobs and it must be painful, dear.
And they're very
you know what?
Perky.
Huh.
But they're. I would never give them up.
Don't
hurt my back forever.
You got another question for her, Jimmy? Another
unsexy question about her boobs?
Go for it.
No, he's got another one. You got another one about her boobs.
No, I just, that was the only one. I think of one, yeah.
Okay.
I'll think if I think of anything.
Would you like to see her in a bra?
I really like you, so I want to show you my boobs since you weren't here the other day.
Yo,
I think you deserve
how nice
that.
How nice would that be?
There we go.
If you would like to.
Well, I'm just going to pull my shirt up because I want to show you because
you
weren't here. And I really like you.
Thank you.
Cock blocker, Jimmy.
No.
I'm kidding.
Yeah.
Look at that. That's stunning.
Wow.
Yeah.
I want to say heavens to Murgatory.
Do they look fake to
heavens
you?
Heavens to Murgatory.
No, they don't look fake. No.
They
yeah.
I think it's good if they look real.
They really are tremendous.
They look completely real.
You're not looking
Please.
At them anymore, though.
No, because I just...
Look at me in the eyes.
Always look at I.
Yeah. Wax on, come and pants. But no, it's, you know, I feel like, you know, she wanted to... I think that she didn't want to show me. I think she wanted to show Anthony.
No.
I was showing him the other day, but you weren't here and you missed out. You were supposed to be here, right?
Did I have to shoot or was I flying home?
I think you were flying home.
What day were you here?
Was this day before yesterday?
No.
Yesterday?
Last week.
Last week?
Friday.
Yeah, it was Friday.
Last Friday. Where was I?
Not here, Jimmy.
I think you were filming.
Oh, you know
something.
Why? I shot. I had a night shoot. And then I slept that morning because I fucking shot till 6 o'clock.
Oh.
Now, here we got to get you out of here, right? You have to leave at 9? Well, that's what they told us. I don't know if it's true or not.
I had a good time. I have a car. That's why. They're
oh, yeah?
Here. Oh, really?
Yeah, and I have to get ready for a convention I'm doing.
Yeah.
What are you doing? Some signings?
It's for the Parts Authority. I'm not sure exactly.
The Parts Authority?
You know,
she just shows up. She's just got to show up and
look
sexy.
I'm doing a convention for, it's like not work related. It's like just where a bunch of guys do this convention thing. They want pretty girls, you know?
Yeah.
So I meet, I do signings, stuff like that, yeah.
It's kind of like you mingle and chit-chat.
sometimes, yeah, right?
Which I love doing, so it's perfect.
Yeah, it's kind of like, because there's nothing worse. Even though you know you're not going to be able to sleep with the models, it just sucks. It's just a bunch of guys, like at a car show.
Yeah.
Bunch of fucking dopey swinging
dicks.
It's nice
to have some eye candy.
Absolutely, yeah. How creepy would it be if Anthony just showed up and just looked in the window and stared the whole time?
Hey!
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Kept knocking on the window.
That windows. Would just be so fucking creepy.
That would be pretty creepy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it's like, and I'll have that image in my head.
Yeah. But he's every very, time I look at a window, he'll be like, oh, what the fuck?
But he's so sweet.
Is he there?
He's a very laid back. Yeah. Notice how I want to look cool, so I put my fucking 1986 Ray-Bans out.
That's good.
Always let the chicks see your sunglasses.
And shoes.
Yeah, no, I have some fucking great Nike sneakers, but I suspect I stepped in shit, by the way, because something is not copacetic with these shoes, so my apologies. Yeah, there's something.
Are you reeking?
That's not the shit smell, right?
It's not shit. You smell something?
No.
Okay.
You want E-Rock to smell your shoes today?
Make sure I actually would. Yeah, I don't think it's shit.
Smell the bottom of your shoes.
Yeah. You want to take a break? You tell you're hanging around or what? You hang for a little bit?
A little bit.
A little bit.
Okay.
A little bit.
Got her car, yeah.
We didn't get anything done with her. I want to know what happened last night. There was some kind of there might have been some kind of arrest.
Told you everything,
but there was
that needs to be told.
Very vague.
Told you.
That's the cops involvement.
Don't worry.
On the date.
I just say this. Don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it.
Don't worry about it.
Turned into a felony. I like that. That's why I like it. You guys had a nice date that turned into an almost felony. There was drinking and fucking eating.
Yeah, it's always
a good time. That was
eating
good.
Meat, drinking, and almost a felony. Nice. That's a successful date.
See, the thing is I want to see a relationship bloom. Not necessarily a marriage or a boyfriend girlfriend, but just a casual dating relationship. Yeah. It could be an occasional once a month.
I could see occasionally hanging out.
Going out.
Going to, but yeah, as long as, you know, you could, I mean.
You're like matchmaker over here, aren't you?
Yeah.
No, but I just, you know, Anthony is, I want to see Anthony happy and,
of course.
I know you probably run into a lot of creepy guys and Anthony's a brilliant, funny guy.
Thank you, James.
Has Anthony's a big, nice house. And you also have really hot friends that you could introduce me to. So let's be honest, that's who it's about. It's about me.
It really is about
you. It's not about my friend or his happiness or fuck his brilliance. It's all about your friends and how they'll be jealous that you have a guy who has a great house.
We'll get together when you come back in June.
For sure. I'll be back.
All right, good. Yes. Why don't we take a break. And maybe Taylor Vixen will be here. If not, Taylor Vixen, one word on Twitter.
Yes.
Thank you, guys.
Join her Twitter.
Yes. Opie and
Anthony. And talk about Anthony all day.
Opie and Anthony show. We're going through the video that's up online now of Jimmy. Earlier in the show, we had, Jesus Christ, what's
that? BJ Penn from the UFC.
And he was in here. great interview, by the way. I had a lot of fun with him. And Jimmy wanted him to put him in an arm bar, but not apply any real pressure to it. Just show him the technique behind it. And he did. And kind of pulled very minimally on Jim's arm after he locked him in. But we're watching the video, the whole process of him locking it in, putting his ankle across your neck and chest and your waist area and pulling your arm. We're watching frame by frame. Your fucking faces are hysterical. This is a video to watch frame by frame.
Oh, yeah. Slow it down.
Every face that Jim's making, especially when he comes out of it. Like, the second Jimmy tapped the guy's ankle, BJ's ankle, Jimmy just starts this face like, wow, and his eyes get all big. it's fucking classic. Where can people see this?
Well, I'll link the video on my Twitter, Opie Radio, but it's on my YouTube channel right now, Opie Radio, same fucking thing. So, God damn it, Jimmy. God bless you. That's your new bit, by the way.
I would do that with any of them. I would love to.
With every UFC fighter, you got to do a little...
I won't get choked, just because we've seen that done already, and it's also...
The choking's not fun. I had that done by a wrestler.
Oh, God.
It's not fun. I can't imagine a UFC guy doing it.
You tapped his little sock. You tapped his sock. Hello, thank you. You're ripping my arm off.
Right after I daintily tapped his sock.
Your headphones go flying a little...
Wow. Oh, beautiful, Jimmy.
I'm twittering photos of my fucking awful
yeah,
face.
Yeah. Jimmy just took pictures of some of the still frames, and God damn. He looks... He's making a face like he's putting a lot of pressure on you, by the way.
He wasn't. He could have, but yeah. he was being gentle.
And he did it, we talked about it earlier, from his chair. He did that sitting in a chair, relaxing. He was relaxing, and he could have ripped your arm out of its socket, Jimmy.
Yeah.
I'm just cracking up at Jim's reaction. It was fantastic. Ow! He's brutal. Brutal.
All right. There you go.
Yeah. What's up?
What the fuck's going on? Era. Of course. Of course. Fucking era. Of course.
What's happening? It's not working.
What the fuck?
Stupid thing.
Of course there would be an era. Of course.
That's a great fucking photo to get signed, though, being armbar like that.
Oh, my God, yeah.
That's fucking cool.
Era on yep. page. Of course.
Yeah, there.
Now, Sam,
your eyeballs. His heel is in your eyeball.
Does Sam have this on video? Sam has a good copy of this, right?
I think Sam's got it also. Yeah.
Yeah, that's fun.
Everyone, like, look at the people looking in the window, just laughing at you.
Stupid Bob Kelly has texted me.
Oh, he did?
What'd you say?
He's just asking how it went. So I'm gonna send him a picture of me being fucking armbarred.
Yeah.
This is what you missed, dickhead.
Come on, you fuck.
What?
Not working out?
Oh, fucking no, man. Try this again. Alright, I think it's on my Twitter now, the link to the video.
She's very nice, Aunt. Nice girl.
Check it out. Oh, check out Norton getting armbarred. Armbarred?
Yeah.
Getting an armbar from BJ Penn from the UFC.
I think I got
Brother Joe's on the line.
A good foundation started there.
I think
for the
you do
next
too.
Time
with the Taylor Vixen.
Yeah, and then of course in between now and then,
she does seem
the
like
texting going on and stuff. Because yep. It's not just you know, I mean it would be it's one of those good bad things when you get a girl that you could just well it's very good especially a girl like that if you could just go in there and you know just pound right away.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
your brother's on the line, Brother Joe.
Some you got
yeah, that's worth waiting for. And eating a whole fucking side of beef.
Yeah,
fuck,
yeah.
Fuck staying away from steak when you have that waiting on the other end.
Yeah, you were working. You were taking care of your cholesterol until yesterday, huh, Ed?
Yeah, actually, my doctor said it was really, really good. So I think I wrecked it last night.
You fucked
with
that
the,
up.
With the meat. No, that was good. I made sure I went down into the bathroom and binged with some of the bulimics down there. I just lined up in the girls' bathroom, and we all vomited. It was wonderful.
I was actually calling in to make a comment about BJ Penn. I'm an avid follower of UFC, as you guys know. Have you guys seen the video of just to give you an idea how strong this guy is and how hard he trains, have you ever seen the video of him hopping out of the shallow end of the pool without using any hands?
Yeah, we watched that earlier when he was on. To even do something like that how the fuck do you do that?
It's amazing because he's only 5'9". I say only, but I would imagine taller guys would have an easier time with that.
Yeah.
I mean, I can't imagine how he
deep
did that
when he does it. He bends his legs till his shoulders are under the water and just
like
jumps out.
Right.
At least standing upright, he was almost chest deep in the water.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, he's not a tall guy, but Jimmy got put in an armbar. It was fucking hysterical. You got to see the video.
I'm going to go check it out.
Yeah, it's really cool.
I'm heading down to AC. I'm doing another tournament. That was the worst bad beat I ever took in my life the other night, and you witnessed it.
Oh, right. Yeah, you got fucking beat. What happened there? Tell
everybody. I had ace queen. Ace came up. Ended up with an all-in. The guy had ace-king. It just sucked. And it sucked. I got caught.
That kicker sucked. Yeah, you ran out of that fucking place.
Oh, I got not only ran out, but I kept going. I got in my car and left.
Yeah, yeah. I thought you were gonna go back up. I thought Joe was going back up to the room. He's like, yeah, I'm fucking done. I'm gonna, you know. I go, all right. There's room upstairs, you know, in the suite, taking a fucking nap, whatever you want to do. He's like, yeah, cool. And then I get a text. Fuck this. I'm getting the fuck out of here. I'm driving.
Oh God.
He's just he got a bad beat that just fucking put him right in his vehicle.
And where am I going now? I'm going down to play a tournament at the Borgata.
Of course.
Yeah, maybe we'll make it back today. All right, man.
Have fun.
All right, Joey.
Later, I'll talk to you, man.
Bye. Brother Joe. I didn't know Brother Joe made the big AC trip.
Yeah, he was actually playing at Harrah's with 2U. I didn't see it because I was gambling, but when he was done, he came over to the Borgata and hung out for some poker. But I got beat bad in poker, too.
Oh, you did poker down there, too?
Yeah, if I'm really getting fucked playing blackjack, I'll take a breather and go into the poker room and play poker because, you know, you just shell out a certain amount of money. You're not going to lose more than you have sitting there.
You can chill a little bit.
You're not betting huge amounts. Exactly.
You can regroup by getting into a good poker game.
You take a break. You just play some poker. And then you get back to the trenches of blackjack, which I did. But, yeah, Joe showed up. But, he got a bad beat on a guy from a guy.
The guy's just brought in something. I don't know what this is. I guess I'm just going to play it.
What?
Will it make sense, Danny, just to play it?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. Hi, Jimmy.
Hi, buddy. Okay. So do you get, do you get people trying you wherever you go? Like, you know, he can go from like, which is what I was surprised at. Like, so what happens? Like, was there a point in that fight where you were like, had you trained enough for the, I mean, like, did you find that at all? Like, you know, like, what was the first thing? Like, I think to take a champion's belt, I mean, you know what I mean? It's like, he seemed like he wanted to really, like, have you ever had a guy in the ring that you wanted to, cause that went like, you know, like, how do you feel? Like, cause there was a, you know, you come from a pretty much, like, what motivated you to fight? That to me is almost more impressive. Like, did you want to retire at any point? Like, and all of a sudden you're like, I was amazed to read this too. Like, what is the, what, oh, you gotta go? Thanks for coming in, man. We're happy to have you. Oh, that was great.
Holy shit. Crushingly now, good.
I meant my interviewing skills.
Yes,
that
of course.
Was very
Who picked
funny.
Up on that? Because I'm sitting here.
D-Boy?
Jimmy usually.
Fucking D-Boy, I knew it.
Jimmy takes the lead on these UFC interviews, and I'm sitting here going, wow, Jimmy's doing a really good
exactly.
job interviewing BJ Penn. I didn't even pick up on the thing.
He was doing a great job. fucking D-Boy heard that with his
stuttering.
D-Boy senses. It's like Spidey.
Yeah, you know what? We rarely play something twice in a row.
I got to hear that again.
No, but you know what? Once was
well,
good.
Well, no, we have to do it again.
I got
to
hear that again.
We have to do it again.
That is so fucking funny.
We have to do it again.
A great clip. Okay. So do you get, do you get people trying you wherever you go? Like, you know, he can go from like, which is what I was surprised at. Like, so what happens? Like, was there a point in that fight where you were like, had you trained enough for the, I mean, like, did you find that at all? Like, you know, like, what was the first thing? Like, I think to take a champion's belt, I mean, you know what I mean? It's like, he seemed like he wanted to really, like, have you ever had a guy in the ring that you wanted to? Because that went, like, you know, like, how do you feel? Like, because there was a, you know, you come from a pretty much, like, what motivated you to fight? That to me is almost more impressive. Like, did you want to retire at any point? Like, and all of a sudden you're like, I was amazed to read this, too. Like, what is the, what, oh, you got to go? Thanks for coming in, man. We're happy to have you.
That's the
ending
best
part. Is killer.
The
best part.
It's fucking funny all the way through, and then the ending is fucking killer.
Fucking A,
God
man.
Damn.
Right on. Good
the
job,
slow
D-Boy.
Clap for D-Boy.
D-Boy!
Today. God damn that fucking Lionsgate hating cunt.
And how about a hand for me for being incompetent?
Yes, absolutely, James.
That was great.
Oh, my God.
God damn, it's funny. What a boob I am.
Someone said they counted 27 likes.
Oh, did I say like a lot? Is that what that was?
Yeah, there was a lot of likes.
Are you kidding?
No, I thought it was just me babbling.
I think
Jimmy.
It beeps right after you say like in every...
No, listen.
Oh, is that... I swear to God.
Yeah,
what do you think we're doing?
Dude, look.
Now we got to play it again. Now we have to play it again.
Here's why I didn't get it. Because I have been... I didn't sleep a wink last night. I laid in bed for 5 hours.
Aww.
Could not sleep. And the night before, I slept for a couple hours yesterday afternoon. But I'm going on probably 4 hours of sleep in like almost 3 days. And I got to go shoot after this. I'm very tired.
Yeah.
Well, you're a sleepy boy.
I'm sleepy, Jimmy.
Well,
Jimmy.
You did a great job. It's kind of taken completely out of context.
I didn't realize they were because of the word like. I thought it was just because of my fucking meandering, boring, awful voice.
No. Jimmy, why don't we play it again?
Here on the replay. I'm on
so
the replay.
Completely
kid.
Appreciate what D-Boy did here.
Oh, no.
Okay?
No.
It was all about the likes.
Those motherfuckers.
And the beep is basically, you know, acknowledging every like.
Okay. So do you get, do you get people trying you wherever you go? Like, you know, he can go from like, which is what I was surprised at. Like, so what happens? Like, was there a point in that fight where you were like, had you trained enough for the, I mean, like, did you find that at all? Like, you know, like, what was the first thing? Like, I think to take a champion's belt, I mean, you know what I mean? It's like, he seemed like he wanted to really, like, have you ever had a guy in the ring that you wanted to? Cause that went like, you know, like, how do you feel? Like, cause there was a, you know, You come from a pretty much, like, what motivated you to fight? That to me is almost more impressive. Like, did you want to retire at any point? Like, and then all of a sudden you're like, I was amazed to read this too. Like, what is the, oh, you gotta go? Thanks for coming in, man. We're happy to have you.
Oh, you gotta go? Hey, thanks for coming in, man. Happy to have you.
Nick in Illinois. Nick.
Yeah, how you doing, guys?
Hey, man.
I gotta tell you, man, I'm never for you guys leaving early, but you can go home. You don't even have to come back the rest of the week. That is hilarious. It's the funniest thing I have heard in a long time, and Jimmy should play that on stage, and he'd get the biggest laughs ever. It is just so funny.
Isn't it? I think it's adorable. It's very endearing.
It was great. It was wonderful. Let's go to Peter in Massachusetts. Peter.
Now I'm going to try to do my shtick. Hi, like, Peter, like.
Oh, Jimmy.
What's up, Peter?
Fucking D-Boy nailed it, man. Every time Jimmy does an interview, I fucking listen to those likes. It's fucking perfect.
I never noticed that you do the like thing.
We all have our crutches and things.
Yes.
Boy, do we.
I would say that those are prosthetic legs.
All right, Peter. A lot of people loving the D-boy thing right
there. Good job, Derek. I do say like a lot, and I fucking hate it. You know what I noticed I say like a lot? When I'm writing out, like when I do stuff for Leno, I would have to submit what I was writing just to, you know, so the standards and practices could look at it. Mm. And I would write my jokes. And I realized I would say, and then it's like, and I would say like a few, like, what am I doing? I said, it's like a girl.
Would you really?
It's a weakness in speech.
Oh,
I won't say it anymore.
Yeah, it's a hard, the hardest thing is to try to get rid of a crutch. I've
like,
had a few over the...
I was...
All right, hold on, let me try something here.
Oh, no.
So do you get, do you get people trying you wherever you go? Like, you know, he can go for like a... Which is what I was surprised at. So what happened? Was there a point in that fight where you were like, had you trained enough? Did you find that at all? What was the first thing? I think it's like a champion's belt. I mean, you know what I mean? It's like, he seemed like he wanted to really... Like, have you ever had a guy in the ring that you wanted to... Because that went like, you know, like, how do you feel? Like, because it was, you know, you come from a pretty much... Like, what motivated you to fight? That to me is almost more impressive. Like, did you want to retire at any point? Like, and all of a sudden you're like... I was amazed to read this too. Like, what is the, what, oh, you gotta go? Thanks for coming in, man. We're happy to have you.
You use your tongue prettier than a $20 whore. Okay, fuck it. What's next?
I truly am a fucking teenage valley girl.
Oh, shit.
Let's go to Ramon in Maryland. Ramon.
Yes, sir. Hello.
Hey, yes, Ramon. Sir. What's up, buddy?
Hey, man, what's up? Put me in the horse thing, man. I heard my voice in the background.
Yeah, you got to lower your radio thingy.
I think he's a first-timer, actually. Mm-hmm. Ramon, first-timer, what do you got?
I just talked to you. You just had me on hold, I guess. But I just wanted to say, man, I love y'all's show. This is like my first time listening to it, and I love it.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, wow.
Thank you, sir.
Look at that. New listener.
Thanks, Ramon.
Y'all talk about some crazy shit, man, but I love it, man. Like, I was in here geeking. Man, whoever he is that does a like voice, man, I'm going to start listening to y'all show all the time, man, because y'all is hilarious.
All right. it's like the first 48.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Cool, man.
And keep the racism down.
Thanks. Yeah, right?
So we got one on the line.
Thank you. I know.
Keep the racism down for a little bit.
I try.
Black guys like it because they hear what whitey is really like on this
honest,
show.
Honest, exactly.
There, thank you, Ramon.
God damn, down
I'm
there
I'm surprised
Maryland.
He didn't call me. The old Ramon bit, I haven't done in a long time.
Ramon.
I got a Steve from Yellowstone, somebody.
There was a, I believe it was Marilyn. There's a video, new videotape out with some officers having some fun with a gentleman.
Is that the one that he's covering up in the box and there's 50 of them running by?
No, it's a young gentleman kind of against a wall.
Yeah.
And a horse comes out. A cop on a horse and bumps the guy smack into the wall with the horse's chest. And then I guess they decided that that gentleman was abusing the horse by wailing his head into the horse's chest and then hitting the wall. So three cops pounced on him and beat the shit out of him. And arrested him.
Last month on the streets of College Park, Maryland, after the home team Terps beat Duke in a basketball game. 22-year-old John McKenna, look at him, skipping there on the side, toward a group of officers on horseback. Seconds later, a swarm of cops unload on the student, and now that victim is promising a lawsuit. But is there more to this story than meets the eye? Let's ask our panel. Fox News legal analyst.
Can we pause that for a second?
Piss out of him.
But what did the guy do? He was taunting the horse because you can't really see it in the video.
They originally said that he was doing something, assaulting the horse or something, and you can't see him doing that. I think the cops just wanted to jump on a little skipping guy.
But he might have been saying some verbal shit,
maybe,
right?
But, you know, if you're saying stuff, it doesn't mean you could get the shit bounced out of you. They just looked like they wanted to tune someone up, have a little fun. And, again, oh, those darned cameras.
They're everywhere.
Yeah, they're everywhere. It's insane to think that a cop in this day and age would put his job on the line and quite possibly his freedom on the line because there's cameras everywhere. But it's not like the old days where you could just beat the fuck out of them and walk away.
But it's like, what was that guy doing? Were they just, what was their explanation of what he could have been doing?
Well, without the camera there, they said he had made some kind of threatening gestures and stuff to the horse. Like Mongo, he's going to punch the horse and knock him out.
We see what they say, Dan?
But
that's the whole thing?
Not quite. Yes,
I mean. Can we see that again, the skipping thing?
Yeah, Mr. Skippy guy. Just skipping down the...
I actually think I saw something.
Did you?
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
No, you didn't see
anything. I did.
Let's take a little peek at this. It's not Breitbart. Breitbart.
We haven't been on Breitbart in a while.
Breitbart.
All right, we got to do something for Breitbart soon. A little Breitbart action.
Yeah. There we go.
All right.
Kelly's Court is back in session on the docket today. One college senior versus a full squad of riot cops. Check out the scene last month on the streets of College Park, Maryland, after the home team Terps beat Duke in a basketball game. 22-year-old John McKenna, look at him, skipping there on the side, toward a group of officers on horseback. Seconds later, a swarm of cops unload on the student, and now that victim is promising a lawsuit. But is there more to this story than meets the eye?
Did he punch the horse?
Fox News legal analyst
Jimmy, what'd you say?
And defense attorney Mark Ott.
Did he punch the horse in the mouth?
No.
Go back a little.
He said, "I think he punched the horse in the mouth when the horse got real close to him." Unless he was trying to feed him a sugar cube. He was either punching the horse or feeding him a little sugar cube.
To be honest with you, I don't know if he was skipping and being a dick.
Obviously just being whatever.
But was he being a dick to the cops or because the team just won? Or was he just being obnoxious?
He pretty much aggressively started moving toward the horses,
but then he stopped.
Though.
Here's what tells me.
Maybe he did some kind of like little shadow box
he stopped
real quickly.
Watch when he stops, though. When he sees the horse coming and he walks toward, he steps towards the wall like, oh, fuck. Watch.
He might have. Jack McKenna dressed in the white pants.
White.
All right, he stops because he sees the horse.
He moves.
Mounted officer. Moments later, a group of officers slammed the student.
No, he didn't punch the horse. No way.
No.
No.
God, I would love to know what the cops saw.
Yeah, what? What
or like, heard.
Like,
he backed the fuck up.
The cops.
What are they doing?
Like, they went after it. It might have been at the same time. Like, they might have been approaching him.
Mounted officer. Moments later, a group of officers.
All right, they're running at him.
The wall. And then strike him repeatedly after
I think
he
basically,
could have been in an area he wasn't supposed to be in.
But I think basically the horse was moving toward him, and I'm sure the cops were like, back up, back up.
Yeah, they have that area cordoned off.
Yeah, they don't want they don't want anyone in that area.
They are tuning him the fuck out.
He's knocked out, he's unconscious, and they're still just pounding him. My God, man.
Let's say hi to Dave in Maryland. Dave.
Hey there, Dave.
He lives down there. What's up, Dave?
Hey, I just want to tell you, that particular jurisdiction in Maryland, they have at least 10 lawsuits every year against their officers for kicking the shit out of people. I was at a bar one night in College Park, and they, it got out of hand. They come in there with their nightsticks and just started beating the shit out of everybody. Me and my brother took off out the back door, but, I mean, this went on for like 5 minutes. They were just beating the shit out of everybody with nightsticks.
Hmm.
Yeah, they're
well, you shouldn't have been there.
Yeah, I was just drinking, minding my own business.
No, because you shouldn't have been minding your own business.
Now, if that video is as it appears, like if there's nothing that happened that we didn't see, or you know, if the guy didn't say I'm reaching for a pistol,
yeah.
No,
but how can you justify keeping those guys hired? They got to be fucking. All they do is make every time a cop makes a legitimate arrest or a fucking. People go to a video like that and go, see, they're just fucking with me. It's like every cop now has to get shit because of that.
He looks guilty of something.
Well,
that's just fucking horrible, though.
All right, let's go to Mike in Indiana. Mike.
Mike!
Hey, guys. Hey. This situation you're talking about.
Yeah. Yep.
Before these guys realized that they were on video, one cop filed a false report. He's already out of there. He's already out. The other ones are probably going to get suspended, and now they're talking to prosecution.
They fucking assaulted the guy.
The one that filed a report said that the horse did the injuries. If this guy had any injuries, it's probably from getting kicked by the horse.
Right, right. And then it turned out on tape that he was on the ground and getting pummeled with nightsticks. Yeah, but
that one's already been suspended for filing false report.
Damn. Man, that's fucked up.
Like, later,
guys. You just can't.
Thank you, Mike.
You just can't do that in this day and age, no matter how justified it is.
But it wasn't even there.
At times. Yeah. Of course, at times, you know, somebody needs a good fucking mouth wrapping.
It escalated really fast.
The guy might have been being a prick.
The guy didn't realize he was walking really close to the horses because he stopped like, whoa, what's this? And then, you know, they obviously were telling him, you know, back off. And then the thing just escalated.
Apparently, if the cops
very
the horse
quickly.
And the horses were there, that area was supposed to be clear of people. Obviously, they were keeping people back.
But he was doing his weird skip thing.
Yeah. His little dance
and he didn't realize
that area.
All of a sudden, he went into this area. It looked like he was confused, like, oh, fuck.
He might have been a dick.
I'm not saying that this is justified.
I'm not defending the cops. I'm just going with what it looks like on the video.
Because
you don't know what the cops are saying, unfortunately.
They could have just turned him around.
You don't know if the guy was yelling and screaming, being an asshole to the horses and cops.
Kenny, what do you think?
How do you scream and be an asshole to a horse?
Yeah.
Oh, you're for faggots.
Yeah, you fucking...
I don't know if you're...
Why
the
long face?
Yeah.
Hey, Voss.
Dude, if you're drunk...
That got him pissed.
Yeah.
If you're drunk, you'll do just stupid things.
Yeah.
You don't know that.
What do you think,
what do you got, Kenny, on this?
It's not fair to comment. Obviously, we haven't seen the whole video.
Exactly. It's out of context.
You know? But from what you see...
That piece of shit was taunting the cops and the horses, and
he probably got what, I don't know.
Kenny.
It's hard to say because it did look like he was being a dick, but it was the way he stopped when the horse approached him. It was like he wasn't being physically like he was going to do it. He was just being a dick.
But you know what? I think at that point the other cops were already rushing at him, and once that trigger is pulled, once they're running at you.
Yeah. That would explain the initial impact. I would almost accept that if they just knocked him down and cuffed him because he's being a dick.
Yeah, but
it was 40 blows after.
Yeah. They didn't know the cameras were on. That's
a little right to explain. they just make cops' jobs fucking harder though. You know people are fucking gunning for cops. You know it's this fucking politically correct society. People gunning, and it's like that just makes every cop's job harder.
It's just I don't know. It does, but.
Can't explain that.
Yeah,
that's a tough one. Just, there are cops that deserve to be fucking fired. They're not always right.
Yeah,
I don't know. I don't know if
I don't know
if we have the whole story. I want to know what that.
I don't know.
Yeah, I want to know what that guy was saying. I mean, they obviously shouldn't have filed a false report. They should have just said this guy was doing this, and we reacted like that, and
we had to control the situation because there was a lot of people down there, so we couldn't let anyone. You know,
yeah, shenanigans.
What happened, Jimmy?
I gotta go.
Where are you going?
Oh.
You just get up in the middle of...
Jimmy!
What's going on? What happened?
He's all right. He's got things to do.
I gotta shoot.
He's a busy boy.
Shoot! Oh, shoot!
But he got up in the middle of our discussion on this.
All right, he looked at the clock.
Teddy D ain't gonna wait for me.
No! Teddy D. He's got stuff to do. All right, Jimmy.
All right.
Well, pack your bags.
Yeah.
Look at you.
I always bring a little bag with me to my trailer. I have my pillow in it.
Do you have your pillow?
Yes.
Aw.
That's what I bring, a pillow.
Why, a lot of downtime, Jimmy? You do a little napping in between fucking scenes?
Today's a pretty busy outdoor scene.
Ooh.
It's, it'll be me, the guy, Dominic will be in it, and I think Ted Danson's in it, and
ooh,
Zach is in it. And Jason Schwartzman's in it, and fucking the guy who plays Jason's father, you guys would know him if you saw him. He's been in fucking everything.
Yeah?
Yeah, I can't remember his name, but he's like one of those J.T. Walsh guys.
Look at you.
Yeah, ooh. So you know. I fight a little bit, and then I go act. That's what I do.
That's what you do.
Like. Hi, Ted. Like. Fucking asshole I am. Just no value as a man.
But it's sad we're sitting right here and we didn't even notice.
So I heard it twice and didn't notice.
I know.
I'm like, I'm sitting here going, wow, Jimmy's doing a great interview.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you know.
I
All right, Jimmy.
Break a leg. Not really.
I'll be here tomorrow and Friday, though, because...
Yay!
You know.
Yay!
Well, let me... You know what? Let me take this opportunity to tell you what's happening on tomorrow's show as Jimmy leaves.
Oh, my goodness. Is it a big...
We got Jim Norton's friend and our friend at this point, Bob Levy, coming by.
Oh, good.
Oh, really?
We got Ashley Dupree coming by.
Uh-huh.
Does anyone know who Ashley Dupree is?
Yep.
Took down the governor, Elliot Spitzer.
Right.
She's coming by finally to say hi.
Ooh. Maybe I could,
You should. That might, you know.
If I pay?
You know what, though? You might as well.
Yeah?
You might as well have that on your bucket list, Anthony. Mm-hmm. Bye, Jimmy.
Tell Ted Danson. I thought, don't say a word.
He
later. You see us both hoping like, what?
He actually. And then he walks out. Prick. Fucking Jimmy rules.
We sat up quickly like, really? Old needy. Does he know us? Ashley Dupree could be part of your bucket list.
The one that took down.
Dude,
Spitzer.
That's
let me,
solid.
All right, let me
that's
take
a solid one for your
I'm
fucking
gonna,
bucket
I'm
list.
I'm going to pop her up over here and take a look-see.
She's right. She's right.
Ash.
I don't know what she's promoting.
Lee.
I don't think she can promote that she's a whore. What is she promoting on the show tomorrow?
Playboy. Images. She's doing Playboy?
Oh, right, right. Yeah, she did a Playboy spread. That what is she showing in Playboy, girl. Danny, you know?
My intel tells me it's boobies.
Boobies?
Just boobies?
But I'm seeing her covered boobies.
Because it depends. Some of these girls get into Playboy and show nothing. They just... kind of almost show something.
You know what?
She agreed to boobies.
There's something going on here.
Now I'm hearing that it's boobies and punani.
And what?
Punani.
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 There's a little manliness there.
Let me see.
I'm looking. All right. Let me pop this up.
You know, I'm glad you're saying this because I'm not a fan. Are you a fan? That picture's hot as shit. The first one that came out where she's... we got the Playboy.
Hey,
the fuck?
You hoarding this shit?
Let me see.
The fuck are you doing?
All right, I'm a fan.
We're
both fans
This is as hot as they can make
her. These black and whites over here too, Ant? Start from the beginning of the pictorial.
All right, let's go. It's already...
All right, we're fans.
The page is... oh, my God.
All right, we're big fans.
Look at that ass.
Ashley Dupree's in the latest issue of Playboy. That's May 2010.
At the ass is very, very nice. Mm-hmm. Let me take a look.
Mm-hmm. That's where the poo comes out.
Now we'll look
where the poo comes out is nice.
We'll look at her vagina.
And she's got the solid tat above the vagina. Well, in between the belly button and the hole.
I'm looking at her the whole body here. That is a nice vagina that looks like it would be a nice fit on a wee-wee.
Sam, I know you don't like girls, but if you did, would this be a good one?
What would you think?
I do like girls,
is
a good one.
Oh, I'm sorry. I got confused.
Thank you very much.
What do you think? What do you think of Ashley Dupree?
I guess I would.
She cleans up nice, Ant.
Yeah, I'm looking at where her poo-poo comes out.
She's not really showing where the poo comes out.
Where her cocky comes out.
She's not showing where the poo
hole.
Comes out, unfortunately. Why isn't she showing where the poo comes out?
We're retarded. I don't know. I want to see where the duty comes
so
out.
Do I
want to see the hole where the doo-doo comes out.
I haven't
out.
Seen this magazine yet, can I see sure. where she makes from?
Yes. Look where... See where she makes.
And we're bummed that they're not showing a little dirt.
Duty.
We like to see where the poo comes out, and we like to see just a little dirt. A little
I want
dirt.
It to be able to go, press the button, pull the chain, out comes the chocolate choo-choo train.
And is it your new favorite bit to talk about where the poo comes out?
Yes. Where the duty comes out.
Maybe we can play Milk Milk Lemonade.
Oh.
Around the corner fudge is made.
That's the one I was just trying to think of.
God damn, that's...
Milk Lemonade.
That survived past our generation?
Fudge is made.
Stick your finger in the hole, out comes a Tootsie Roll.
Yeah. And did you ever imagine that would survive our generation?
No!
And the young go-getters what are they calling you, baby face? What was your...
I don't have... What do you, hey, Kenny!
I think he's... Milk.
Oh, he is?
Lemonade.
And how great is it that it survived our generation?
I know.
And the kids are saying
on.
The exact same fucking thing we did when
it's
we were
passed
your age.
On like a cave painting.
It's just, it's too clever. It can't.
It really is.
It's one for
really
the ages.
Is.
Yeah. Kenny.
Yes, sir.
I forgot what Sam Roberts' new nickname is now that he's the big overnight jock on Hits 1. You haven't even told anyone yet.
I know.
But he goes by what name on Hits 1?
Sam, no, say it.
Sam Roberts.
No.
No. What? Who are you?
Come on, tell the whole backstory.
Come on.
There's no backstory.
Yeah.
No backstory.
We were discussing what my on-air name would be. This is a conversation that I told Kenny about, which I shouldn't have because he's just decided to make things up because of it.
No, man. Someone on the way in today was talking about your new name. It's not a
rumor. It was probably Club Soda Kenny.
Well, yeah, he was the person. You're right.
But
Kenny, what's the name? Come on, say it.
There's no name at first.
Don't be embarrassed.
Well, at first I told Kid Kelly that my middle name was Wood, as I told you guys recently.
Yes, it is Wood.
And for a moment he said, what about Woody Roberts? And I informed him that
Woody Roberts wouldn't.
That was probably not a great idea.
Woody Roberts wouldn't fly.
Yes.
Well, that's your name now.
No, it's a better one.
And so he said, okay, well, I like Sam Roberts. And I said, I like that name, too.
Because it's your name.
And so I'm Sam Roberts.
So you're lucky. I had to be
Greg. T-Bone!
I had to be Greg Opie Hughes for a while.
T-Bone. That makes sense.
I dropped the primetime when I'm on Hits 1.
I see that.
Do you? You're not primetime?
Just Sam Roberts.
No, there's a better
Sam
name.
Sam Roberts isn't
Kenny.
A good one.
Kenny.
Really?
No.
Kenny.
They wouldn't let him have prime time because it's overnights.
And it's not prime time.
Right. So, Kid Kelly said, I'm on prime time on the Opie and Anthony show because the morning is the prime time.
You should be called No One's Listening Roberts then.
Well, I don't know if that's fair. Kenny listens.
That's nice. Kenny listens, Roberts?
Yeah.
What?
You know how many Nickelback songs I have to sit through to hear little baby boy talk for 15
baby
seconds?
Baby boy.
Baby boy Sam Roberts.
Is that what they're calling you?
No. This baby is something Kenny made up.
Kenny?
He talks so fast, his voice goes up like 3 octaves.
Where's an air check?
Yeah, why
My
don't we have
God,
an air check
we
yet?
Should have an air check of your
I can give you air check.
Drivel.
Can we please have an air check?
No.
You know what you can learn from listening to his show?
What?
If you eat Kentucky Fried Chicken, it'll take 5 years off your life, but it's worth it.
That was a break.
There's a break.
I mean, no, that was a break.
It certainly is.
What song were you talking about?
I don't remember for that one.
A break in entertainment.
KFC, I'm sure it was.
Oh, I don't know what that's supposed to be. If you give me 5 minutes, I'll give you air checks.
Yeah, let's get some air checks.
Okay.
Let's take a break, and we're going to listen to Babyface Sam Roberts do his first.
I want
to
hear it.
His first show for Hits 1. I guess he's doing overnights now.
Wow, is that what he's doing? So what time does he...
3 to 6.
3 to 6 a.m.
Yeah.
This company, let me tell you about this fine company.
There's going to be two people working here doing everything.
Sam does our show, right?
Yeah.
And then he's doing overnights for Hits 1, but it's... should we say it's voice tracked?
I think
no,
everybody knows that.
He's there live.
All right. It's
there live.
But Sam has to wait around here until 3 or 4 until they... come up with the playlist for the overnights, and then Sam could do his show for Hits 1.
Wow.
They don't make anything easy around here. Why can't they have his songs ready for when we're done with him?
Helping guy out.
Yeah, no kidding.
Help a half a
hour. Right. He's got to wait around here for about 4 or 5 hours. And then they finally go, all right, here's the song. And the songs are going to be the same ones they did the night before they play 20 songs.
If you
want to
be
again.
A big radio star, you know, you got to get in there and, you know, battle it out.
Why don't we take
the shit?
Why don't we take a break, Ant? But let's remember, tomorrow is a big day. Oh, so you got Bob Levy, who's hilarious. He's done some great radio for us the last few months. You got Ashley Dupree, who's in the latest Playboy magazine. I think we're going to get along with this, Ashley Dupree. And
I hope she's not.
And also, I'm excited about this. I don't know Anthony so much, but the Stanley Cup is coming by to say hi. The actual Stanley Cup is coming by to say hi.
Oh, we had that happen once before over at Gay Rock.
We sure did.
Yes.
Why are you calling it Gay Rock now?
Because that's what it is now.
Yeah, you're right. So we're gonna check out the Stanley Cup tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe we can make a duty in it.
Would you think we can put our heinies? Yeah. We'll put our hiney on top of the Stanley Cup and make poo-poo in it.
I want to make it to the Stanley Cup.
Make.
Danny, how bad would you want to make it?
I would love to make in the Stanley Cup.
Oh, that would be great.
Just
a big load of poo-poo coming out of your coolie hole.
But we would show the Stanley Cup some respect. It wouldn't be, solid
one. We'd clean it out afterwards.
A nice solid one.
I can't promise that.
I can't either. I had fucking linguine and clam sauce last night.
Oh, God.
Red or white?
Red, Kenny, red.
Which way?
Red. Red. And I bought a telescope. Maybe I should talk about that next.
Oh, shit. You're not stargazing.
Are you?
Oh, you got a telescope?
No, but I want to get one.
All right, we'll talk about my telescope.
You know what you're doing,
next.
By the way? I know you.
Shut up.
You're looking at people in Jersey.
What? No,
it all depends on how powerful his scope is, but let me tell you something.
That fucking universe is a fascinating fucking thing.
Yeah.
We'll talk about my telescope.
Well, sure it is.
All right? Because Danny's excited. He wants one. And I know exactly where to go and who to see.
Really?
You
got to see Myron.
Myron?
I'll explain
Cone?
Next.
The telescope guy?
The telescope guy, yes.
I'm going to have to start brown nose.
Could be the biggest fucking creep I've ever met. Well, I'll get into it next.
Telescope guys, of course they're creeps.
Biggest creep I've ever met, but I knew I was getting the telescope.
Well, that's what you want.
We'll explain that and other things next. Stay there.
COC, clean my wound.
So, it's a quickie, whatever. I went to B&H.
B&H, that place rules.
There's a place in Manhattan, it's called B&H. What is it called? What's the whole name? B&H,
B&H Photo?
Electronics or something?
Electronics.
Because they sell everything.
B&H Photo and Video.
Photo and Video. And they're not advertisers, but you know what? When you come across a company that knows what the fuck they're doing, they really should just get an acknowledgement. Our agent, gave me a nice fucking wedding gift, right? But I didn't like it. I didn't like it, so I brought it back to B&H, and I got a store credit.
B&H?
And the store credit is just sitting in my desk. Actually, it wasn't even in a desk. It was in a box. I'm rearranging my whole place because we got a new arrival coming within weeks at this point, right? So I discovered that I got this store credit. I'm like, holy shit, it's like finding money. And it was for a lot of money, like something like $800. That fucking Rob Eatman did the right thing. Wow. So I go down there. And I got some wireless headphones for the girl.
Mm-hmm. Because
she likes to watch a little TV and stuff while I'm trying to sleep.
Certainly.
So now she got her wireless headphones. Nice little gift. And that was to disguise the real reason why I went there.
Right.
I got her a gift so she wouldn't be so creeped out at the gift I got myself.
That you just bought something for yourself.
Which was a almost telescope, I call it.
Almost telescope.
Yeah, because a telescope is just a little... the telescope, if you get a telescope, Anthony, you're a little too close to the heavenly bodies.
Yeah?
So there's something called, like, I don't know what the real name is, but it's like an almost telescope. Let's just put
an
it this way.
Almost telescope.
It's better than binoculars, but not as good as a telescope.
Is it like a spotter scope?
It's like a spotter scope. I believe that would be the name, Anthony.
So if you set up in the, sometimes hunters use them for spotting.
Sure. They're good for bird watching.
Okay.
If you got a rare bird in a tree about a half mile away.
Right. People are calling it a field scope.
A field scope.
A creepo scope.
A creepo scope.
Is another word that's coming in. That's very,
dude,
very funny who said that. Okay.
Dude, I go to this B&H, right? It's run by, I think they're Hasidic Jews, right?
Yes.
This
very,
fucking place rules. If you ever get your ass to Manhattan.
Yeah.
Because the locals know already. And you're looking for stuff. You go in there. They spend so much time with you, it's almost annoying. They will not just go, here you go.
Yeah.
They will look up reviews in front of you. They'll talk you through the whole thing. It's amazing.
And then the whole delivery system is all automated. So, like, you'll see conveyor belts moving
above
on the
your
ceiling,
head.
And your order comes down. I don't know where they learn such efficiency like that. Such wonderful efficiency.
Well...
Are you trying to say...
What?
I'm just saying
they've learned how to take stuff and really run it through and remedy it quicker. They've learned... I believe when you finally get your item, mm-hmm. that the final solution to the problem of getting your item has been taken care of, is all I'm trying to say.
You know how many people came up to me in that damn place and said they're big fans?
They really do.
You're not allowed to listen to electronics. How are you big fans of ours?
Dude,
well, maybe they're allowed as long as the sun is still up. I don't understand their rules, but they got some crazy rules.
Let me inform you of something if they're listening and don't like my sense of humor. I have spent upwards of probably $60,000 to $70,000 in that store. Probably.
Knowing that, they would probably,
to 100,000.
They would probably sacrifice their own relatives knowing that
exactly.
You're a good customer.
I bought all of my Canon HD, XL1
The reason they have the conveyor belts and all that shit above your head is to cut down on theft. So
yes.
You buy your thing there, but you can't just, like, you know, take it up to the counter.
No.
Now it goes down into the fucking warehouse, wherever that is, and they
yep.
and then it's delivered to you.
It efficiently comes out.
I knew I wanted to get someone's calling it a pedoscope.
A pedoscope?
I didn't get that one.
Rapescope.
Fuck, look at that one.
They're calling it a rapescope, too.
Fuck, dude.
A rapescope.
I live very high up in a building here in Manhattan.
Yes.
Which means it cuts down on the light of the city. So now you got, you can enjoy some orbs.
some orbs. Now you have the darkness also of the river.
That's right.
So it's not like
I live right on the river.
Do you say good morning and good night to the river?
Not yet. I'm not that old yet. No, I just
make wonderful friends.
Right. So I knew I wanted one of these things.
Yeah.
Dude, I made up. This is what I told the guy.
Oh no.
Me and the kids. I said.
All right, so right away, lie.
Well, because you walk into the telescope fucking section, and there's no one in there.
Yeah.
Except for this guy, I think his name was Myron.
You got a boner.
Myron behind the counter. You feel like a creep.
Yeah.
Because you know what they're thinking.
Of course.
So I'm like, yeah, me and the kids, I live in this building, and we want to look across the river, I said.
Across the river?
I'm just lying blatantly because I feel like such a creep.
So you want to look at Jersey?
I want to look at Jersey with the kids, I said. I don't have any kids.
Yeah.
I will have one soon.
Yeah.
But I was making believe I had kids at that age that were into exploring.
Yeah. That's it.
The guy behind the counter had, he had to be pushing 60, okay? Jet black hair that was under a hat. So I think it was a hat hairpiece. With creepy glasses, and I go, yeah, I'm looking for, I'm not looking for binoculars or telescopes, something in between. Could you suggest something? He fucking had a product in front of my eyes, going, this is the one I use.
He was speaking
my language, Anthony. He goes, this is the one I use, and then told me all the bells and whistles and what I could do with this.
Uh huh.
In code, he talked in code. But
yeah.
Knowing that he was a creep, I knew that I was buying a fine product at this B&H.
All right. So what parts of Jersey were you looking at?
Well.
Right across the GWB?
Well, I had to work on the focus, so I was looking at some, you know, some other things.
All right. Yeah, work on the focus.
I had to fine-tune the lenses.
All right.
You know.
Yeah.
Looking at some cross... some cross streets, and you know, I had to focus on smaller objects
yeah,
to kind
of
fine tune the thing, and
yeah, learn how to aim it properly at your
all right.
Your
wait,
target.
Dan, slow down! I'll tell you which one I got.
Oh, it's there.
I think so.
Oh my God!
Let's see.
Ghoul.
Did you get a good one?
I got a pretty good one, according to Myron. He said
Myron
it's the only
said
one
it's
to
good.
Get. Something like
that's
something like that one.
Oh God! Oh my God! You creep!
And, yeah. And he got all excited when he goes, and we're gonna throw in a free tripod.
Say, don't worry, I'll make my own.
Right. He goes, if you buy this one, I'll throw in a free tripod. This guy was getting off fucking selling me a creeposcope, as everyone's calling it.
What's the power on it? Like, how many times magnification is it?
Dude, let's just put it this way. I live on the west side of Manhattan. I could see clear to the east side of Manhattan.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
You could count the bumps on the nipples? Is that what you're saying? That's beautiful. And it's not like people leave their window shades open in these buildings in Manhattan.
No,
a very private, modest town.
There's not one fucking apartment that has a shade in Manhattan. It's so fucking bizarre.
Do you know how often I stay in hotels that I have no idea if the windows are frosted, mirrored, or blacked out, or just open windows? And I have the shades open, and I'm just walking with half a rod. I wake up in the middle of the night with a piss hard on and the lights on, and I'm just walking around.
Yeah.
You don't care. You're up high. For some reason, you wouldn't do that on the first floor.
No.
But for some reason, you get over a certain altitude, and it's okay to walk around with no clothes on and a window right there in front of you, but that you wouldn't do on the street level.
Yeah, no. When I was looking through this thing, I was just kind of trying it out. I counted.
Yeah.
100, close to 100. I stopped counting. Close to 100 creeposcopes in other apartments.
Creeposcopes. And they can see
everyone has them
now.
Well, all right. It's like an arms race, though. You got one, I got one. Now
you
what?
You should get one, like, fucking at one of the observatories. like one that's just a giant dome that's in your fucking window. It's electronic, has motors on it, big mirrors.
Winston has one of those.
Winston.
Yeah, he's my creepy neighbor that we crashed his karaoke New Year's Eve party.
Yeah,
a year and a half ago, and he has one of those big, huge fuck. It has to be a telescope. It's this big. The lens. Mm. How big is that? That's fucking big.
That's like a 10 plate. 10-inch mirror.
Almost like a plate.
12-inch mirror. Something.
Yeah,
like
I
that.
I don't know what the fuck he's looking
That's
at.
Pretty nice.
Maybe he's
that.
Maybe he is looking at the stars.
You know, that would be kind of cool. Somebody was like, oh, it's like a sniper game. That would be kind of cool if there was a way
actually
to have a sniper game where you have a telescope with crosshairs and some kind of lasing unit on it, and you look for other people that have the same thing, and you have to pick them off without getting picked
funny
off.
Funny you should say that, because my old, you know Buzzy. Buzzy's in town.
Sure.
My really good friend. We go way back, and he's in town on business. He works for Cox Media.
What media?
Cox.
Media.
He's coming by Friday. He'll throw me under the bus with a story or two. But he was over, and he said exactly that. He's like, this is like a fucking sniper. Like, we're sniping.
You just kind of look and go, this person has no idea.
No fucking idea.
Not
I was
a clue.
I was looking at a cross street that I'm telling you was, I can't even tell you how fucking far it was. I'm like, you're
really
fucking, and we're reading license plates.
And just
plates.
Seeing people walking
and
around.
And we're reading license plates off cabs
they have
and
no
shit.
No clue. Yeah, you should see what it looks like through an ACOG.
But Danny wants a real telescope?
Oh, yeah. I've always wanted one for a long time. I remember being a kid, I asked my grandmother for a telescope for my birthday, and I got basically what amounted to like a periscope with really cheap, you know, like binocular lenses. You know, I couldn't see shit.
No.
I could barely see across the street. And I was like,
well, you gotta stretch it out like a pirate's telescope.
Uh-huh. That's right. That's exactly right. It's
Captain
sucked.
Jack Sparrow's.
It fucking sucked.
A looking glass, it's called.
So, yeah, I want to get a good one because, you know, I used to live in Queens and it's all, you know, with all the light from the city, you can't see shit.
No, you got the Road Warriors telescope.
But now I'm further out on the island and I was looking outside. I'm like, shit, it's pretty goddamn clear and dark.
Right.
I want to get a goddamn telescope.
Mm.
I live so high up, I see the lights of the city below me.
Below you? What?
Below me.
Oh.
Below
I thought you
me.
Said something else.
And my brother Brett, I told the Brett story, right? He gave me his binoculars when he got married. He was bummed because he moved to a place he can't use them anymore. These fucking high power binoculars were amazing. I told you a story where he would set his alarm clock to watch the girl shower next door.
Oh, fantastic.
Did I tell you that story? His old apartment.
I think when we were talking about the girl that was across from us at K-Rock that we used to
watch.
Okay,
his old place in Huntington, you know, the owner of F.H. Riley's, a terrific restaurant, 400 New York Avenue in the heart of Huntington Village. Brett lived next door to this house where bathroom window, old school house, so it didn't have the fucking, what was it called, the frosting of the windows or whatever. And this girl would just, pretty hot, would get fucking naked every morning, get ready for work. And Brett would set his alarm clock, even though he didn't have to get up. It was before the restaurant. And he would set up snacks on the window ledge and just eat snacks and watch this girl go through her morning routine every fucking morning. And he said it got to a point where she definitely knew he was looking.
Yeah.
And she had no problem with it.
You could pop up
no
videos
fucking problem with
of nudity and perversion and whatever. But there is something just so hot. And about the whole voyeuristic thing.
Way hotter.
Of watching a girl.
Way fucking hotter.
Taking her clothes off with a telescope through a fucking window.
Way.
I don't know why.
Way fucking
but it
hotter.
Is. It turns a 3 into a fucking 8. It's
ridiculous.
Because they're nude
and
live and you're watching them.
But the best part of the story was he would set up fucking snacks.
Like, is it the movies?
Yeah.
Some popcorn Twizzlers?
Yeah. I'm not getting a camera for
a
my
large
telescope.
Farva? A large farva.
What a large farva.
And
what a liter of cola.
And you know what? At this point, fucking the HD Flip people should be paying me. Mm. I was gonna get another HD Flip at B&H, but the guy, and this is how cool they are over there. And I'm telling you, they're not sponsors or anything. They're just a solid business. He goes, don't buy it. There's a new one coming out today, and we don't have it yet. We're going to have it, like, later this week.
That's the Slide, right?
The Slide HD looks fucking phenomenal.
I'm going to pick this up, yo.
I think I'm going somewhere else today to get it, because I can't go all the way down to B&H, unfortunately. 4 hours of recording on the new Slide HD.
You know what I'm
going to
do the second I get this new Slide? I'm going to videotape my other four flip cams.
It's a good idea.
Yes, I'm going to set them up and videotape them all that I have just laying around. But this one looks really, really, really cool.
It looks really good.
Yeah, it's got a bigger video screen on it. It's touch screen.
I mean, it looks like a girl's phone where, you know,
it flips up.
It flips up like a girl's phone.
So you can text like one of those phones.
Yeah, but what a way. This thing looks fucking great.
It really does.
I got to get this today. So I think that was released today or yesterday. It's called the Slide HD.
Where's it available, though? How come they don't have it over there at...
I don't even mention anybody.
Yeah?
Because, you know, the place I'm probably going to go and get it, because I have no choice, I don't like those people.
No, huh?
No, they don't give you the fucking same treatment.
Are you talking
I don't like those people. I'm not saying who I'm talking about, because they might be sponsors.
Are you talking greatest...
Not
purchase?
Saying a word. Not saying a word.
Talking about the people at better than adequate paid for something and took it home place.
I'm not saying a word.
Yeah, I don't like going there either.
Travis wants to know if it's awesome acquisitions.
I'm not saying a word.
Yes.
Just customer service.
Awesome acquisition.
When you ask someone to help you in a store, you don't want to hear, what?
Yeah.
It's like, relax, man. I'm fucking buying shit here. What's your job, really?
I think the problem is that they don't get commission at Awesome Acquisition.
Right. No.
And so
I'm not
they
even
don't
saying
give,
who it is.
They don't give a fuck whether you buy something
awesome
or not.
Awesome Acquisition.
I'm really not saying who it is. But
I don't like
there's two
standing
places,
there.
There's two places I like right now. The Mac Store, incredible as far as helping you out.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And this B&H, incredible as far as helping you out. Other places.
J&R's great, too. You ever go down to J&R?
J&R Music Girl?
They're, independent,
World?
Just like B&H.
Oh, J&R. We used to do gigs for J&R. Yeah.
I like J&R.
They're down near Wall Street, right?
Yeah, they got that whole block down there.
Yeah. Actually, they're really good, but it's just too far away. I would love to make a trip there to buy some stuff.
You know what I don't like about Awesome Acquisitions?
I didn't say who it was.
Well, I'm just saying, this is what I don't like about Awesome Acquisitions. When you have to stand there and wait for somebody to come up to help you, and there's people milling about, or some idiot discussing the simplest fucking thing, and they can't figure it out themselves, and they're wasting a salesperson's time, and you're waiting there just to say, could you get one of these? I did my research at home. I'm here to make a purchase, not discuss what fucking plug is used for this fucking thing that this old piece of shit doesn't understand. Mm-hmm. I want to purchase.
There you go.
I want to acquire.
Hey, I don't want to lose the sense of feedback. Michael Spano. Michael writes us from time to time. He writes from New York City. I used to live on the 45th floor of 3 Lincoln Center.
Yeah.
So that's a fine building. Wow, this guy makes some fucking money. He writes, I bought a telescope with a camera feed to my 62-inch TV. I used to be able to see in any window perfectly all the way down downtown, like Houston, and watch on my TV as it scrolled around.
Wow. That's pretty cool.
That is far. How far would that be from Lincoln Center, Houston Street?
Wow.
Couple miles?
That's far,
couple
yeah.
miles? And he
could see for miles and miles.
Miles and miles.
Danny is saying that, I won't say the name of the place, I'll just say... PC, the guy that wanted to blow me in the tree fort, is the absolute worst.
Mac, Apple Dicks. Apple Dicks. Sucks.
Apple Dicks.
Jesus.
They are the worst. I used to go to Apple Dicks for for car stereo stuff.
Yeah.
And like I would stand there and just wait around, and like I'd be standing there for like a half hour, and like I have to pull somebody from another department, and they go, "Oh, it's not my department."
Yeah,
well, find the fucking guy whose department it is.
Yeah, where
dude.
Is
like,
he?
What do you want me to do?
Where the fuck is he? Apple Dicks.
Customer service, for the most part, is non-existent.
You know what happens?
It's ridiculous.
And this is the truth. Nobody beat the Wiz.
Huh?
Nobody beat the Wiz. Oh, I'm the king, the Wiz! Nobody beat the Wiz.
Long way to go for that.
The Wiz! Look at me!
Let's go to Rich in Ohio.
It's fucking great.
Rich.
I was just on the Elaine TV. Going out the with the fucking yeah. Wiz guy.
Hey, Rich.
Hey, guys. This isn't telescope, but it's definitely a classic peep. Back in the day when I was like in middle school, we had the full-on Porky's thing. We went to a day camp that had a sail loft for the sailboats up above the shower vents. And when the girl counselors would come in from swim lessons, they would always... totally stripped down to get all the lake shit off of them, and we would go upstairs behind the wall in the sail loft and look down through the shower vent. It was the first time I ever saw the most perfect 16-year-old breasts in my life. It was amazing. That would have been heaven.
He thinks we're laughing at him.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
You have a fine story, but the Seinfeld clip was playing about the Wiz. So.
Watching the guy in the crown,
yeah.
The Wiz guy doing his walk. He leans back and takes his fist and kind of goes into his chest.
Oh, was that a funny fucking episode?
Right on, brother. Right on.
God damn.
Thank you, sir.
I'm the weird. And then there was Crazy Eddie's back in the old days.
Well, he was crazy.
Crazy Eddie. And then there was another place in New York.
Wasn't he insane?
Yeah. Well, his prices were insane.
But was he insane?
He was insane and ended up going to prison.
For something.
For all kinds of improprieties with the SEC and stock
disobedience.
Shit, things like that. Then there was this guy called Uncle Stevie, and it had a song. It went, Uncle Stevie loves you. He goes, I love you. And you can never understand the price of what he was talking about because he'd blurt out the model number and the price all at the same time. I used to crack up at this guy because he'd go, pick up a Sony HD3059623.
Yeah, really?
And it was the price and everything.
What the fuck is that?
You pick up the Zenith HT20956-2893. And it was the serial number model of the thing and the price. And he wouldn't say dollars or cents. He just blurted it all out. He had no idea what Uncle Stevie was talking about. So he used to say, instead of I love you, it was I fucked you. Because Uncle Stevie fucked you every time with his stupid prices.
Nice.
Sony Trinitron 3896B25832.
I gotta find audio of that now. I don't remember that guy.
Uncle Stevie loves
I don't remember
you.
Him.
I love you.
Let's say hi to Brian in New York. Brian!
Hey, what's up, Creeper?
Hey, buddy.
Come on. So there's so much light pollution, and they have to know. Your wife must know. You can't see a star, even out in Nassau County.
Wait, first of all, of course my wife knows. She's in on this thing. She's cool. I'm not trying to make believe I'm fucking looking at stupid shit.
She's peeping.
But I got paranoid when I went into this B&H. I'm like, I don't want them to think I'm doing what I'm obviously doing. So I made believe I had a whole family with kids. That,
fair enough. Hey, as long as you got it covered, bro. And Xander's the gayest name ever. Punching out.
Oh, that's God. Steve Carlisi named his son Xander, right?
Damn. You're looking at naked girls?
No, this guy was a creep.
Yeah?
He goes, let me show you the one I have. And he's kind of giving me the wink like, we know what's going on here.
You want the tripod?
His fucking jet black hair under a hat.
Yeah.
I tried to get a picture of him. I failed on that one.
Do you have the payas? Do you have the curls?
I don't know what's going on with that because a lot of the guys had the payas, but then a bunch of them didn't. So I don't know. I don't get it. I don't know if it's a new thing or are they mixing in some other fucking
little yarmulke, some guys, and some of them wear the wacky hat, the whole hat with the brim.
They might be mixing in and other
some have the payas. Some tuck the payas under sometimes.
No. They're starting to allow some outsiders in there.
Wow, really?
Yeah. Also, they were mixing in some other
Jews.
Yeah,
when I bought a video camera there last year,
yeah.
and I did not deal with a Jew.
You didn't?
No.
Well, that's stupid on your part.
That is stupid.
No.
I'm telling you, that's stupid on your part.
Everyone there is so, like, they train their people so well. And Ope's right, like, they will never try and make you buy something.
No.
Like, I was going back and forth between two cameras. One was, like, $200 more, and he's like, you really don't need to spend that extra $200.
Wow.
Yeah.
So it's the best store in New York.
Obviously, you weren't dealing with.
No, obviously.
a black guy was my cashier this time around.
What?
Yeah, so they got some blacks.
That place is like a Benetton ad.
They got blacks.
My God. Do they have any Chinese?
I didn't see.
Any Chinese?
I didn't see the chinkies.
Working in there? Jesus.
I didn't see none.
The Chinese? That's where I got all of my green screen paint and stuff. Where else are you going to buy fucking chroma key green paint?
Yeah, they were fucking...
Love that place. They got everything.
They're fucking cool, and there's a lot of fans in that store. I couldn't believe how many people are fans of the radio show at B&H, so I want to say hi to them. And I didn't get a deal.
Hello?
I didn't get a deal or nothing because I was using stupid Bob Eatman's money.
Yeah.
That dope's money.
Jesus.
That fucking useless piece of...
Oh, my goodness.
Agent.
Goodness gracious.
Hi, Bob. Bob listens to us now so he could be informed.
Does he?
A little bit.
Mm. You don't like thinking that he's listening.
My last...
I don't like thinking anyone's listening, tell you the
truth. And his latest email, he referenced, like, a recorded bit. He referenced, like, me on Ron and Fez. I'm like, I haven't been on Ron and Fez in over a year.
Oh, I heard that when I was driving. He was listening. By the way, that was Ron and Fez.
Yeah.
He was listening to the best of from Ron and Fez.
And I happened to be on that day.
Our show?
Yeah, I think so. He goes, oh, you were really funny on Ron and Fez. I'm like, Ron and Fez? I mean, I would love to be on Ron and Fez. But it's been a while.
I heard that whole thing, too.
Okay.
And I at first, I'm like, did Ope hang out after the show? And then within a second, I knew it was best.
I don't think Bob knew. I think Bob really thought that.
Of course not.
I did that day.
Yeah.
And he wanted to make it known that he's listening, I guess.
Isn't that great when somebody says something? Yeah, oh, I was listening to the show today. Oh, yeah? Yeah, I heard something really funny. Oh, yeah, what? And then they say something that didn't involve anyone from the show.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, thanks. Great.
That's my world.
Thank you. That's wonderful.
Yeah. That's my world.
Good times.
I heard everyone be funny except you.
Aww.
It made me sad.
Wah, 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 wah.
And I went home and cried.
You cried. Tears on your pillow. It was all blurry through the telescope, through my tears.
Yeah. See, you finally admitted he's not funny. I told you. See, he's not funny. See,
let me post.
I knew the whole fucking
copy
time.
Copy paste.
I told you guys. You could see my post from 2007.
I was the first one that said it.
I was the first one to claim he wasn't funny.
Yeah. After I wrote Anthony has AIDS.
But we're really fans of the show.
Yeah, we love the show.
They just don't get it. Yeah. They don't understand. They think we're not fans,
and
but
Jimmy,
we really are.
I don't like when Jimmy has an opinion. That upsets me. And I turn the radio off. He should just stick to telling jokes. Really?
Whatever. Mm. All right, guys. Let's get the fuck out of here.
I am all for that, Opie.
You know what? Can I do something?
Get out of here.
Just to wet everyone's whistle for tomorrow's show. It's our new bit. Wet the whistle. This is what we'll get into tomorrow.
The sound of generation. Sirius
XM.
It's one.
Coming up in the next 20 minutes, Theory of a Dead Man. Gaga.
Sam Roberts.
Sirius XM.
Radio, y'all get hit with
hits.
One.
Oh, no. Oh, my God. Did they pitch him up?
Kenny,
did they pitch his voice up, or are they pumping pure helium into the studio?
Kenny thinks because on Hits 1 you guys speak a lot faster that it just makes your voice higher. Try it. See if you can make your voice, not on purpose, just
by
try
talking faster.
And you got to have a little energy, too, because, you know, they're
all right, let me see if I can find
a higher energy type show.
Text.
Huh?
Kenny's
convinced because Sam has to talk so fast that it makes his voice higher.
I'm trying to,
Hey, you don't have to do it. Let's get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, fuck that. Why? You know something?
Let's do it tomorrow.
Yeah, we'll figure it out tomorrow.
I got it.
See if it makes your voice higher.
See? I got just,
your focus?
Yeah, my
your
focus.
Telescope? Your fucking tripod?
Yeah.
You gotta jerk the old tripod?
No, it is weird, though. Legit. What is it called when you get one into the Lincoln Tunnel in Jersey? I can now see what the traffic's doing because I have to use the Lincoln Tunnel a lot.
On the Helix?
Yeah. That's one of many things you could do. Yeah. I'm not going to sit here and make believe. But
You should call in as a
fucking one of the CBS phone force.
I was looking at the helix from my apartment going, oh, my God, man, this is some big delays today.
And you just see the people, like, miserable in their cars.
You actually could see their faces.
Misery.
And I'm telling you, I live so fucking far away.
Yeah, you're across the river. That's fucked up, man.
All right, guys, it was a fun show today. Jimmy's fucking video is killing already, but just in case you don't know, on my YouTube channel, Opie Radio, the latest video is called UFC's BJ Penn Puts Jim Norton in an Armbar. And I think Anthony suggested it, or maybe I think it was Anthony. You got to watch this video frame by frame, because the faces Jimmy makes are classic.
Before and after.
You got to screen cap every fucking frame to see Norton's faces he makes as BJ Penn is putting him in an Armbar. And BJ Penn, after the show, admitted that he couldn't find Jim Norton's chin.
He couldn't find his chin. He wanted to lock it in under Jimmy's chin. But since that chin doesn't exist...
Yeah, Jimmy was lucky that's all he got to do to
him. It's going to be a defense. Him.
So check that out on the YouTube channel there.
Right? On the YouTube.
And also the video, Worst Toupee Ever. I'm very proud of that one. That guy is a fucking mess, if you haven't seen that one yet. And other things. A lot of things.
Of course.
Oh, look. E-Rock doing the head cheese day thing is up there, too.
Oh, that's a good one. I haven't seen any of the head cheese videos yet.
It's pretty good.
Yeah.
It's pretty fucking good.
I'll see that one.
All right, guys. We'll see you tomorrow. Stick around for Ron and Fez. Bye.